It's a fall football Saturday here in Middle Georgia. We're in Macon at the home of the Mercer Bears. Five-star stadium, the lone home game for the Bears during their three-game non-conference schedule. Abilene Christian has brought some fans along with them from West Texas. They've got a couple of guys from the state of Georgia on their roster as well. We expect great spirit, a great atmosphere for the students and the fans alike. We're striking up the band for college football, presented by Ford. Here at Five Star Stadium, as it's a SoCon Southland Conference battle. Ingalls College Football, Mercer getting ready to go at it against Abilene Christian in a first ever meeting between the schools. And hi, friends, and welcome back in, along with Jared Singleton, Pete Yannity with you. Abilene Christian, a ball club that in three games so far this year, 0-3, but they've shown they can score some points. They've got a first year starting quarterback in Peyton Mansell, an Iowa transfer, who so far has three 200 yard passing games.
You know, he is a very dynamic player, Pete. He brings a lot of different options. I think that big-time experience at Iowa is great leadership for this offensive unit. We should see a lot from him today, and especially with that wide receiving core that he has.
Drew Kronick, the head coach of the Mercer Bears in his first season, raved about the playmaking ability of Mansell, and we talked with Kronick this week.
Yeah, definitely. He makes a lot of plays with his feet. He keeps the feet. He keeps the great vision of the field and makes the right play, makes the right move. He's going to make the right decision and take care of the football, which is critical for this offense.
Fourth-year junior Harrison Frost has earned the starting job at quarterback for the Bears in place of the injured Robert Riddle. You don't want to say that a guy is a maintainer, but honestly, that's the best label to put on him. They want him to manage the offense and get the ball to the playmakers around him.
Give it to the playmakers, make the right decisions, take care of the football. Don't put the football in a position where it can get turned over. You said it best, he's a game manager, and there's nothing wrong with that. You have to have that, especially when you have a guy like Tyre Devison to hand the ball off to each and every play if you need.
The Mercer Bears are one of four Southern Conference teams that are playing in the fall. They're trying to bring the conference its first win so far in the autumn months ahead of the conference schedule beginning in February. Frost and Company trying to get it done against ACU. We kick it off after this. Better day for football here in Middle Georgia. Sunshine, some clouds overhead, but a cool enough day. We're going to hear the pads popping on the turf at Five Star Stadium here in Macon. Let's go downstairs and welcome in the third member of our broadcast team, Kristen Banks. Kristen?
Thanks, guys. I talked to Coach Kronick earlier before the game, and he's so excited to play at home today. He said it's an opportunity to get better with a new coaching staff, new players, and new schemes. But he's really excited for his guys to get be able to play in front of their parents. He said he's had them caged up. They're on lockdown. They haven't been able to go home due to all the COVID protocols. But today they have the opportunity to be rewarded for all the hard work they've been doing and hopefully get fans excited for SoCon play in February. Back to you guys.
Drew Kronick, you see the gaudy record, what winning he did at both Reinhardt and Lenore Ryan. And there is Adam Dorrell, now in his fourth season guiding Abilene Christian. Won three national titles, had three 15-0 seasons, a 30-game winning streak to close at his alma mater, Northwest Missouri State. He really has great respect for Drew Kronick and the fact that both guys working their ways up through the lower ranks up to Division I. I'd like to remind you, Cox, an exclusive partner of all Mercer broadcasts. Cox bringing us closer together. Abilene Christian to kick it away. The runoff by Blair Zepeda. And, well, the Bears going to watch that one sail overhead. Fred Davis was the man the ball was closest to. They were not going to kick it to DeAndre Johnson at the start of this ball game with his ability.
No, he's definitely that special teams threat that, you know, can really set the tone and get the energy going for your offensive unit. So, I'm excited, Pete. We've got fans in the stands. We've got the sun out. It's fall. We've got football. I've had some great food before the game. I'm ready to go.
I'm always happy when you have been well fed before we work together, my friend. It's Jared Singleton, the two-time All-American in his days playing at Wofford College in the Southern Conference. Wasn't that long ago. Harrison Frost guides the offense. Keep an eye on number five, Fred Davis, along with other playmakers on the boundary. And early on, up the middle it goes for a Mercer Bears team that comes into the ball game trying to establish a run, averaging 133 yards over their first two games, and there is Tyre Devison.
And again, he's going to be the bell cow. They're going to get him going early because when you get the run game established early, it sets up so many things for play action. It makes your quarterback kind of ease into the game.
Second down and eight, and nice job stepping up that time as the Abilene Christian defense led by Hunter Keir a linebacker and a senior out of Washington, Kansas.
This defense is going to have their hands full. You know, last week playing against a really good physical Army team, you know, they had some issues with the, you know, filling the run gaps and filling those run lanes. This week, they said they worked on that in practice. We're going to see if they communicate well and make sure that everyone's in the right position so they can kind of slow down this run game for Mercer.
Bears 43% on third down so far. Grab is made. Steven Peterson, he got a foot down. I don't believe he has enough for the first down.
And that's what you want to see, Pete. Kind of get your quarterback rolling out of the pocket. You know, make some easy throws early to kind of settle him down. They're playing in front of their crowd. There's lots of emotions, lots of energy going right now. But you want to settle your quarterback down and get this offense going and try to convert as many third downs as possible.
And a nice job on the first completion of the game. Indeed, it is for first down yardage. First touch from scrimmage for Johnson. He's got a hole, and eventually he'll be pushed out of bounds by the safety, Brian Bullock.
And again, this Mercer offense, they do so many different things with the run game. Lots of motions, lots of shifts. And when you have the athletes that you have here on this offensive unit, you have to really keep your head on a swivel because you don't know who's going to have the ball, and making sure that you're doing your defensive responsibilities is very critical for this Abilene Christian team.
Johnson was moving in motion on second and five, dumped underneath, caught by Ethan Durham, true freshman, able to stay on his feet.
One thing about that play, Pete, you see the defense running to the football. You see a lot of gang tackling. You see guys running with their head on fire, and that's exactly what you want to see from this Abilene Christian defensive unit. You have to get these guys on the ground. You can't allow them to get yards after catches because that just creates a lot of havoc, and you want to make sure you get off the field and win the third down.
Bears trying to go 2 for 2 so far in third down tries.
And third down is something critical that both coaches talked about winning from an offensive standpoint and the defensive standpoint. Can we maintain drives if you're Mercer? That's the question you want to be able to answer on third down. And right there you see great push up the middle, great push by that very physical offensive line to get that first down and keep this drive alive.
Slot back Brandon Marshall, and that's the beauty of having Devizin, because you've got to respect the fact there's a power guy, but that time you saw the speedster find the hole.
And that's what we were trying to figure out. Who's going to step up and help Devizin this fall and moving into the spring? And that's what they're trying to figure out. And who's going to be that guy that really complements this offense?
First and 10 right at midfield for the Bears. Marshall again out of the slot. And he'll push the pile for about another yard on the first down carry. They call the position that Brandon Marshall, DeAndre Johnson, and others play in this offense the Joker, but it's really essentially a wingback.
Yeah, and it's a lot of that kind of old school wing T type offense where you have that wingback that's a really good athlete. He's the guy that can tote the mail up the middle, but also can catch the ball out in the flats if needed. They're going to utilize all their weapons that they have and really try to find that guy. Great player right here. As you see, he bounces to the outside. And again, because of Devin's is such a threat in between the tackles, these tailbacks that are part of that group are going to have to really step up, as you see here on this replay.
Fred Davis eventually pushed out of bounds by ACU's Tristan Anderson. And now the Bears drive continues to the 30, another first and 10. Davis picked up 16 yards. This time, Abilene Christian reacting on the right side. Tyree Devizin and company, he's not the only one that gets it done out of the backfield for this Mercer offense. They've got others they will utilize throughout the ball game. And again, trying to get the ball to as many different players as possible to get touches. That time, it was Julian Barris, a young player in this Mercer offense. Devizin back in, has a hole, gets the first down.
You can see the power that he brings whenever he runs the ball. I mean, that was just old school right up the gut, Pete. Nothing sexy about that. Just handing it off to your bell cow and letting him do what he does best. Great job by that interior offensive line, getting their heads and their feet moving and kind of creating those running lanes so Devizin can do what he does best.
Abilene Christian's allowed 10 red zone touchdowns and 18 trips by opposing offenses this year. Not that time. Ball's on the ground and recovered by the Wildcats. Opportune time. We talked about turnovers in the pregame, and Jack Gibbons, the lone returning starter from a year ago, is the man who comes up with it. The Bears, a promising drive ending by putting the ball on the ground.
Well, you see great penetration right there to start the play. And then you see right, looks like someone kind of whiffed on their block, and that allowed a guy to come in unblocked And then a turnover right there, and Givens doing a great job. Givens, again, we said is going to be the leader of this defensive unit to kind of make sure everyone's in their right position. But again, getting that turnover, kind of stopping the drive, fantastic job by this Abilene Christian defensive unit.
Jack Givens, not only a standout player, one of the brightest players in the Southland Conference. That time, not a whole lot happening on the end around to Kobe Clark.
Kobe Clark, one of their top players on offense. They're going to try to get him the ball early and often. We talked to Coach this week. He wants to get Clark the ball about 8 times in the first half to kind of get him going. We'll talk about him all day, but watch out for 88. He is definitely the impact player for this Abilene Christian offensive unit.
Notable that when healthy, this Abilene Christian offensive line is very junior and senior oriented, but again, health is the key. Tyrese White, his first touch of the game. White gets some hard yards to bring up a third down and manageable. A Mercer defense that has a new coordinator, of course, with the new coaching staff coming in as Joel Taylor runs the show. They're trying to do some creative things defensively, and they hope today they can really demonstrate that.
They are. And again, third down right here, third and short, third about medium. How can this Abilene Christian team continue and sustain the drive? Again, both coaches talked all week long about winning third down, how important that is.
Wildcats just 26% on third down so far this year, but an opening down the sideline. Room to run. LJ McConnell finally knocked down inside the Bears' red zone.
McConnell's one of those other backs that really helped Kobe Clark out as far as complimenting him with this offensive unit. Great job by the outside skill players sustaining their block. That's a tough job. That's a tough thing to ask your wide receivers to hold those blocks that long. But when you do it, you get big plays like this from LJ McConnell.
57 yards, and just like that, Abilene Christian knocking on the door after their defense came up with a big stop inside of the 20. On the fumble recovery by Gibbons. Another back they use quite a bit. And Jeremiah Dobbins close to another first down.
Pete, what a gaping hole that we just saw right there in the middle. I think you and I could have both ran through those holes right there, Pete. But that's what you got to do. Create big opening lanes for your tailback and your skill players to make plays. But the big thing here for Abilene Christian, can they finish this drive? They had a big turnover. They had a big play from one of their skill players. Can they finish the drive with points on the board?
Lance Wise and the Bears now trying to come up with some stops. And at the very least, hold the Wildcats to just a field goal. Little shovel in front of him by Mansell. That should go as a touchdown pass. There is a flag thrown, so for now, hold everything. As he simply flipped it in front of him and taking it on into the end zone was Davon Johnson.
Rob Lodewijk, offense, number 21. 15-yard penalty. Free play, second down.
Yeah, and you can't do this right here. You know, they kind of took this out. They call this high-lowing a guy, but you can't block a guy that low from the outside. The thing about it, Pete, you hate seeing penalties like that because it really kills the momentum of the drive. And, you know, hopefully they can bounce back despite having this big penalty, which was going to be a touchdown.
That'll certainly back things up and bring up a second and long for an Abilene Christian team that so far on third downs has not been good offensively.
And right here, you want to try to run a play that's going to, you know, maybe get half of that yardage back to set you up for a third and medium.
Clark moves in motion. Mansell, Clark, see if he can find the seam. Oh, and a good open field tackle that time delivered. Luke Ward, the safety, able to run into him.
Great play, and again, great way of being able to get the ball to Clark. I think that's his third touch so far of this game, this first half. But it creates a more third and manageable. And again, third down is critical. Can they convert this and try to continue this drive to get points on the board?
Kobe Clark turned in a 78-yard reception last week in their loss against Stephen F. Austin, one of 6 catches he had in the game. He is good with the football in his hands. A big yards after the catch guy. Third down and 7. Handoff. And gonna be, I believe, a yard shy of the first down for Dobbins.
And great job by Dobbins, kind of letting his linemen get into their place, get movement, and create a fourth and short. I think they're going to go for it here, Pete, and I would too. Set the tone early. Let this team know that we came all the way from West Texas and we mean business. And that, and going forward on fourth down early, I think that lets the message is very clear.
Wildcats, 3 of 6 on fourth down tries. They were really good a year ago, 64%. And Adam Dorrell, the head coach, wants to talk it over, so he calls a timeout. First one used by either team in the ball game so far. Scoreless, just under 7 to go, opening quarter here in Macon. Jared Singleton and Kristen Banks, Pete Hannity with you back at Five Star Stadium here in Macon, Georgia. Abilene Christian out of the timeout, looking to go for it on fourth down and 2 from the Mercer 9.
And this is the right call, I think. Early on, you want to send a message early on that you're here for business, and going for it on fourth down early, especially this part of the field, is the right call.
And that's the right call for Jeremiah Dobbins.
Great job by Dobbins, being patient, letting the guys up front get to their blocks, create movement, and then having the vision to sneak it back to the left side behind that massive offensive line to get it into the end zone. Watch here, this offensive line just creating movement and that vision to be able, and that patience to just slip out the backside. Great job of finishing the drive, and again, points off of turnovers is huge. Turnovers are going to be key today, and this offense right here, being able to finish the drive after that turnover, fantastic job, great start.
Just a second turnover forced by the Abilene Christian defense. It happened in their defensive end of the field. They turned it into a long scoring drive. Jeremiah Dobbins on the fourth down conversion, picking up his third rushing touchdown of the season. Extra point is good.
Please refrain from blowing whistles in the stands. I can have no whistle blown in the stands.
And you don't hear that all too often from the referee. Jeremiah Dobbins, part of a two-headed monster out of their backfield. Their head coach really loves both his running backs, Tyrese White, as well as Dobbins, a true freshman out of Lubbock.
And they really complement each other well, because when you have two running backs like that, along with a guy like Kobe Clark on the outside, it really creates a very well-balanced offensive unit. And that's exactly what, you know, Coach talked about this week as far as wanting to surround Peyton with great leaders and great impact players that can make this offense balanced.
Their top rusher from a year ago, Tracy James, has moved on, so they were looking for those two to step up. Both White and Dobbins were well over 2,000 yards rushing in high school. So now to kick it away for a second time, Abilene Christian trying to pick up their first win of the season, one of three games they're playing here on the East Coast. They visited Army up in New York State a few weeks back. Later this month, they'll play in Charlottesville against Virginia. Fred Davis at the goal line. Slant thrown behind him, room to run up the middle, out across the 35, but you get the impression this one's coming back. Fred Davis, one of the electrifying players that Drew Cronic wants to get the ball in the hands of on this offense. He's a redshirt freshman. There is also an Abilene Christian player being attended to by the athletic training staff. And a hold will bring it back. We'll take a timeout. Give you an update on the... As they continue to attend to the injured Abilene Christian player, Mercer about to go on offense. Let's send it back down to the field. Kristen Banks is with the men's head basketball coach for the Bears, Greg Gary. Kristen?
It's your second season as head coach of the Mercer Bears basketball team. What are you excited about this year?
Excited to be able to get on the court and be able to coach again. That's what I'm excited about. Also, we've got a lot more depth this year, which will definitely help. The more depth you have, the better your practices are, the more competition there is, the better each guy gets.
How has practice looked different during this time?
we've had to be very flexible just because you some days or some weeks you have two or three out. You just got to really be flexible and understanding. Coaches, we like certain things. Hey, this is how we do it. But with this situation, you have to be flexible and you got to understand a little bit that things aren't going to go the way exact way you want it. So you can't let it get you frustrated.
Will games look any different this year?
I'm sure they will. Yes, definitely. I mean, just because it's an unknown, so we don't know what's going to happen. Obviously, there's going to be less fans probably initially. Right. So it's just that's not my problem to worry about. Our problem is once we're playing is to get the guys that play us at the highest level they can.
Great. Thank you so much, and we're excited to come out and watch y'all this year.
Thank you. Back to you guys.
All right. Thank you so much, Kristen, and keep an eye out at the Mercer Athletic website for more details on the basketball season. Greg Gary did a fine job last year. That is Abilene Christian's Greg Green. He was the player who was just laid out on that kickoff return.
Yeah, and that's the thing about kickoff return, Pete. It's such a dangerous time in the game. You see right in the middle of your screen, he takes a big hit right there from the Mercer player. You hate to see plays like that, but you're really glad to see that he's up and headed to the sideline. Hopefully they can get the right protocols to see, make sure he's okay, and I'm sure they're going to go through the concussion protocol with him.
Green is a junior linebacker out of Houston, Texas, Westfield High, but the good news is looks like he's walking off under his own strength, and so they will attend to him. But that was quite a physical play in a ball game that we've seen some hard hits so far. So Mercer was driving the first time they had the ball to start the game, only to see Tyree Devison have it knocked away on the fumble. That turned into a 7-play, 79-yard drive for Abilene Christian. And Adam Dorrell, his team playing game number 4, having nearly won their opener against UTEP on the road against an FBS team. And then they played Army and actually had a very solid second half against the Black Knights up at West Point.
That's the thing about this Abilene team. As the game goes on, they seem to get stronger and stronger. But I tell you, I've been very impressed. I know the Mercer offensive unit, I know they fumbled on that opening drive, but they were able to move the ball at will. You know, you saw some runs up the middle. You saw them utilize their backs with a lot of the kind of jet sweeps. You'll see that offensive line right before the snap, they'll kind of shift and bring a guy over. You saw the quarterback kind of rolling out, getting comfortable, making easy, smart passes. This seems like a very well-balanced offense. We're going to see right here, they have to go the length of the field. Can they kind of continue that momentum but protect the football this time?
Abilene Christian trying to bounce back from a heartbreaking overtime loss in the Dallas area last week against Stephen F. Austin. Mercer comes off that tough defeat up at Army, and Johnson, room to run. When he gets on the corner, he is tough to contain.
And you know, the reason he's able to get to that corner is because of that great chop block. As you see right here in your screen, watch number 5 come and just kind of cut that outside leg. That was my favorite block personally when I was playing back at Wofford. But when you can seal off that edge, it creates an opportunity for your skill player to hit that sideline at full speed. It's going to give you an opportunity for a lot of first downs and sustain the drive.
14 yards that time. This time they sweep left.
And again, you see the different things that this offense can do. You know, before it was kind of handing the ball off to Devison up the middle. It was kind of, you know, get two, three yards in a cloud of dust. Now they seem to have those skill players that can really take it to the outside and kind of help complement what Devison does up the middle. And as a defense, you have to make sure you're in the right run fits. You know, when you have a dynamic offense like this, it is critical that everyone is on the same page and understands their responsibilities.
6 yards that time for Johnson. Second down, little dump off underneath Devison. Suddenly, the white and purple jerseys converging on him. It'll bring up third down and short.
Big third down, but as you see here, Devison, he does it all. He can run it up the middle. He can also slip out the backfield. He has great hands, low center of gravity type guy, so it's going to be hard to take down. They do call him the bowling ball, but a big third down right here. Can they keep this drive alive? And it looks like we may have a guy jumping, which creates a new, fresh set of downs for the offense.
Chike Wankwo on that last tackle for the Wildcats, who with about 5 minutes to go here in the opening quarter of play in this first ever meeting between the Abilene Christian team out of the Southland Conference and the Bears from the Southern Conference.
5-yard penalty results in a first down.
And that time Jacob Thielen jumping, and that'll give a fresh set of downs for the Bears.
And those are things that Coach talked about this week that we have to get rid of. You can't jump off sides on third and short. You can't have the ball in the wrong hand, which then causes a fumble. Little things like that is what he's trying to work on to help change the culture of this team and minimize those type of mental mistakes.
Harrison Frost, fourth-year junior out of Kennesaw. Inside handoff.
Oh!
And once again, ball knocked away and it'll be picked up and returned. A second fumble so far in the early going. That time, beneficiary once again for Abilene Christian. And it's taken by Kadrin Johnson on the recovery. And ACU this time gets it in Mercer territory.
A great play initially up the middle, but as you see here, when you have a group of guys swarm to, when you have a defense swarm to the football like that, guys ripping at the football, you work that every Thursday in practice. They do that every Thursday in walkthroughs, working on turnover drills. Guys coming up, one guy holds them up, the other guy that's coming late to the party, his job is to rip at that football. Great job right there by that Abilene defensive unit. And again, creating a turnover, can this offense put points on the board off of that turnover?
Two lost fumbles so far for Mercer. They had turned it over six times in their first two games. So now a first and 10 for Mansell and company at the 35 of Mercer.
And again, Mercer's doing a great job, I believe, offensively, just driving the ball, playing smart offense. But the thing is, you can't have turnovers like that in the midst of a drive because it's going to just kill the momentum.
Frustrating opening quarter for Drew Cronick and his offense. The Lasser defense to bow up again. They had an opportunity to get a stop down close to the goal line on fourth down on the first offensive set for this Abilene Christian team, but Wildcats were able to convert on the Dobbins touchdown. Mansell, the rush comes in a hurry, and he's taken down. Looked like a blitz that time, and actually getting to him.
Great
on the
job.
Stop, the Bears defense, and a great job by Richie Coffey.
Great job by Richie. And you also see Isaac, the young freshman we were talking about. He's coming to the party as well. That's what this defensive unit needed to do for this Mercer team, to kind of shift the momentum after that big turnover.
Told you about the Bears trying to do all kinds of things defensively. That's the seventh sack so far, playing their third game of the fall. Mansell, ability to extend plays and able to get some of the yards back. It'll bring up third and long.
And you see right there, they were kind of going for that big play. You know, when you get a turnover, you know, you can expect that offense to come out with a play action fake to try to get a cheap one down the field. And he was looking Kobe Clark's way, but they're doing a great job, Mercer's defense. They kind of have a safety over the top to help that corner out because they know he's an offensive threat. But again, watch where 88 is on the offensive unit and see if they're giving that defensive player some extra help guarding him, because he is definitely a lethal threat.
Zach Hopkins, the linebacker for the Bears you just saw, they're trying to get a third down stop. Pressure comes on Mansell. Connecting Clark. Going to depend on the spot where he caught it was mighty close to the first down yardage.
Great job by Clark, and as you see, he does a great job of understanding where the sticks are. Offensive line does a great job on pass pro, and that's one thing we'll get to later in the game, but fantastic job of making the completion and understanding where the first down marker was to help sustain this drive.
Harrison Poole, the cornerback for the Bears, did everything he could on that play, but a nice throw and a good catch by Clark. And now a first and 10 at the 25. Abilene Christian driving again.
Empty backfield.
Oh, and the ball on the ground. Bears say they have it. And it appears that Mercer has indeed forced the first Abilene Christian turnover of the ball game, and a big one at that to get it back, trailing 7-0.
And I think this is just a simple, quarterback center exchange where he just kind of dropped. You've got to see it all the way in there, big fella. You know, being a former center, I understand sometimes as a center, especially when you know you have to get to that next level on the block, you want to get out of there real quick, but you have to do the first things first, secure the snap, make sure the quarterback has a good exchange, and then proceed up to that linebacker to cut him off. But big turnover for that Mercer defense and not giving up points. Hopefully this offense can now settle in and put a nice long drive together and put points on the board.
Great awareness by Baron King, the defensive tackle, on the fumble recovery. Bears get it back at their own 25, which is essentially where they would be after a touchback on a kickoff. So a fresh set of downs, and look at the bowling ball go to work.
I love seeing that, Pete. When you just see a big group of guys just kind of pushing the pile forward, great run on first down, creating second and short. When you're able to run the football like that on first down and create second and three, it opens the playbook up to open to anything. And that's a fantastic job by the big boys up front.
And in that case, Fred Davis acted like the bowling ball, Devizin. It was Davis, the joker on the carry. Now he's going to try to find his way outside. Does a good job just to get back close to the line of scrimmage.
So many different weapons. You're seeing them be able to run power right up the middle. Then they're able to run with the kind of jet sweep look and the motion look. All these things is really hard for a defense to kind of keep up with. And that's why it's critical for guys like Jack Givens on defense and this other these other guys on the Abilene Christian defensive unit to understand their responsibilities and not try to be Superman, but just do your job. And if you do that, you'll be able to hopefully slow down this Mercer offense.
Bears were able to convert a couple of third downs on their opening series that ended with the fumble. And that turnover has led to our lone score so far. Devizin fighting, and looks like he was able to lunge for the first down.
Great job by Devizin, but did you see that penetration by the defensive line? You have to have that more often, especially early on that first and second down, to try to create timing issues, create issues as far as the running back being able to see where to go. You have to get more penetration if you're this defensive front for Abilene Christian.
Bears perfect so far on third down conversions. Frost, Johnson. First he looked outside, then inside, eventually thrown to the turf by Gibbons, but another nice positive play for Johnson, the top playmaker.
And again, Frost is making the right throw. He's not trying to get greedy, go down the field yet, but I think having him roll out of the pocket kind of gives him that comfort that he needs early on to build that confidence up. I wouldn't be surprised later in the game if we see him kind of open up and go deep off of those play action fakes.
Picks up eight on the play. First reception so far for Johnson. Taking the handoff inside is Al Wooten. Wooten, one of two true freshmen. We saw Devin Crosby, who fumbled it moments ago, that have been backing up the senior Tyree Devizin this fall.
And again, third and short. Who's going to win this third down battle? I mean, this is critical. You know, Mercer really needs to kind of get some momentum going and put points on the board here. Third and short, I wouldn't be surprised. You know who's going to get the ball here, number 34, the bowling ball.
Perhaps our final snap of this opening quarter of play. Look at that, a shift that includes the offensive line. Devizin, you called it, and another first down.
You know, all that window dressing, moving guys around, shifting guys right before the snap. What that does is it tries to get the defense to, one, jump off sides, number one. Number two, it makes it really hard because sometimes your responsibilities may change because you have an extra offensive lineman on one side of the ball versus, you know, how the traditional set would be. But again, all they did was run a simple power play. It wasn't anything special, but a simple power play with a lot of different window dressing to make it look pretty.
And indeed, we arrive at the end of quarter number one. Couple of turnovers, just one of them costly over the first 15 minutes for the Bears. Abilene Christian up 7-0. Ingalls College Football here in Macon. Abilene Christian playing far from home in West Texas. They own a 7-0 advantage here at Five Star Stadium in Macon. As we get ready for our second quarter with Jared Singleton and Kristen Banks, Pete Yannity back with you here at Mercer. Fumbles, three of them so far, have been a big story in the opening stages of the game.
You know, turnovers are a drive killer, Pete. And the thing about it is, this Abilene Christian defense has done a fantastic job of forcing two turnovers and getting points off of that. But they also turned the ball over themselves. Great job by these defensive units on both sides, creating turnovers early in this game, which have created a lot of energy for both sides.
And around Brandon Marshall on first and 10 from the 50. That has worked well. You call it a jet sweep, call it an end around, but it's been effective when they've run it with Marshall or Davis.
You know, not only are they doing it with Marshall and Davis, but you look at these first quarter stats, Pete. You know, they're really spreading the ball around. It's not just Tyree Devizin who's carrying the load, which we've seen in years past. You're seeing guys like Johnson, Davis, and Marshall. All of them are kind of, you know, contributing to this offensive unit, and it really makes it tough, you know, to try to slow that down because you're trying to figure out, well, which guy do we stop? All four of these guys are doing a fantastic job for this offensive unit. Can they convert third downs and protect the football? That's going to be key as we continue to win this game.
going to be close and bring up a third down and short on the carry by Wooten. Stepping up defensively, Troy Hargrove for the Abilene Christian defense. They came in allowing 418 yards per game. Gave up a big number against their Southland Conference rival Stephen F. Austin last week. And of course, both these teams have played Army, and that's never going to be good for your stat sheet, especially your rushing defense. Once again, Devizin doing the honors and another third down conversion. Bears have been phenomenal so far on third down tries. They ran a perfect 5 for 5.
Again, when we talked to coach this week on both sides, they wanted to win third down. And it's so critical to win that third down. And it makes it easy. When you're doing third and one, third and two, it's really easy to do exactly what Mercer's doing, just running straight power and just running it down the throat.
Another first down presented by Cadence Bank as the Bears are on the march in Abilene Christian territory once again. As you see the play clock under 10. And Frost almost running into his teammate Marshall. Ready to bring up second down and long. Good read that time on the short side of the field by Hargrove and that Abilene Christian defense.
And that defense is now starting to communicate well. You have limited capacity, so it's not an issue of crowd noise here. It's really important for Jack Gibbons, the leader on that defensive unit, to make sure that all guys are understanding their responsibilities and in the right place.
Devizin with Johnson behind him. Option left, quarterback keep and room to run. Harrison Frost says he wants to get into the big yards act on the ground.
And the thing about when you're running an option, Pete, you know, it gives a quarterback like him the opportunity to make a decision, you know, figure out what's the right play. Do I pitch it? Do I keep it? Do I hand it off? And right there, he did a fantastic job of reading the defense and taking what the defense gave him and making sure he got a first down and also protect the football.
That puts the Bears as a team over 100 yards rushing in the game to this point.
Goes more window dressing, shifting guys over just to run a simple power play. Now they're going to check it to the sideline. Let's see what they do.
And Drew Kronick emphasizing that. It was a 13-yard gain on that last play for Frost, but they will shift pretty much on every play. Here's Fred Davis. He gets down to the 20-yard line.
And the game is real simple, Pete. I mean, you know, when you do all that shifting and things like that, it's challenging for a young defense that's maybe not used to that. And when you have a young defense like this Abilene Christian defensive unit, sometimes all that window dressing and shifting things around can be very confusing. But at the end of the day, it's very simple. Either they're going to hand the ball off to Devizin or they're going to give it to one of their athletes like you just see here, kind of running to the outside. And again, such a balanced offensive unit. I think that this Mercer team is going to cause a lot of problems in the SoCon come this spring.
Another first down carry for DeAndre Johnson. So once again, the Bears inside of the red zone. And the Bears have entered the Roland Abbott and Desort red zone. Remember back in the opening quarter, they were knocking on the door before the fumble that Gibbons recovered, and that turned into a 79-yard scoring drive for Abilene Christian. That time, they were ready for the bowling ball for the Bears. Devizin knocked down, might have gotten a yard.
I tell you, someone didn't make their block up front. You know, when a guy comes that free, that open, I mean, he really just, his guy just whiffed, and he just came in there and just really, you know, created a lot of penetration. Again, penetration is really the one thing that messes up this offense. When you're able to kind of create a new line of scrimmage, it makes everything so much harder for this offensive unit.
This time, Marshall with room, and he's in. Touchdown. Home folks with something to cheer about. Bears are on the board. I was going to say before that play, with all the shifting they do, you would think they would be a difficult team to defend in the red zone especially.
Yeah, but the thing is, Pete, when you have a guy like Devizin that you know is such a threat from a power perspective, it creates so many opportunities for guys like that to hit the outside seams as far as being able to create plays on the edge. And that's what you're seeing right now. All these different jet sweeps, it kind of creates a problem for this Abilene Christian defense. What do we try to stop? What do we slow down? Do we want to pack the box? And by doing that, it creates a lot of stress on the outside. But again, if we set things up on the outside, we allow impact players like Devizin to make a difference.
Come out on the field.
The doubt an extra point is good. First touchdown of the year for Brandon Marshall. We're tied at 7. And
I'm sorry, beat.
Seven-seven ball game here in the second quarter. The Bears, a long drive that began.
Nice long drive. They won third down. They were able to take a lot of time off the clock. And again, Pete, such a balanced offense. They can run up the middle with power. They can do the jet sweeps and beat you on the outside too. Lots of balance on this offensive unit and a lot of different guys contributing to that success.
Drew Kronick in this game has seen his team give it up twice. One of those led to a long Abilene Christian scoring drive, but his defense forcing a turnover and being on the plus side in the turnover category, something these teams are striving for today. That has been an issue over their games played this fall. Long kick by the kickoff specialist for the Bears, and Devin Folser kicks it out of the end zone. It'll be a touchback, and we'll see Peyton Mansell in this Wildcats offense again. So two teams that have very little film on each other, really don't see each other when preparing for other games over the years because they don't have many common opponents. And I sense the first quarter was kind of trying to get the vibe, but I think we're kind of in that flow we were looking for.
And the one thing that coaches do, you know, they do research on who the offensive coordinator, defensive coordinators are, where they've been, and what are the different schemes that they have played in those different programs. So it's been a challenge, obviously, trying to prepare for a team that you don't see a lot of, but you have to go off of, you know, what the different coaches like to do, and then just trust in your system and just go out and play ball.
Mansell, the Iowa transfer, now the starter, and he finds Clark. Good job in the open field that time. Nice recovery. You've got to be able to make the open field tackles against this ACU offense. Tyler Mackey just did for Mercer.
Yeah, and again, this Mercer defense, they're young. You know, they have young guys like, you know, Mr. Isaac Dowling that's, you know, definitely have been an impact player the first two games so far this year. You know, they have to have more guys like Isaac kind of step up, especially as they get ready for this spring.
You just saw Dowling in the middle, and this time not a whole lot happening for Dobbins. It'll bring up third down.
Here we go, third manageable here. Okay, third and five. Can they sustain the drive? Again, both coaches have harped on this all week long to us about how they want their offensive unit to win third down. And from a defensive standpoint, can you get off of the field on third down to get the ball back to your offense?
Ken Stanley, NG linebacker, sophomore out of Waycross with that tackle. ACU 2 of 3 so far this afternoon on third down tries. And behind the intended target, McConnell, out of bounds it'll go. And we will see the punting unit for the first time today.
And that's a huge win for this Mercer defense. Winning third down, getting the football back, which should be in pretty decent field position. And again, your offensive unit just took 10 minutes off the clock, and now they're coming back on the field with energy and momentum, see if they can put together another nice long drive that ends with points on the board.
Logan Burke comes into the ball game, averaging about 35 yards a punt. Wind blowing from his right to left here at Five Star Stadium, or so it appears. Rugby style. And it'll take an Abilene Christian bounce and eventually be down just inside of the 40. Never a chance for Landon Miller to return it. Drew Kronick, all he has done is win as a college football coach at Reinhardt in the NAIA ranks, and then at Lenoir Ryan. From not too far from here, Sharpsburg, Georgia, about an hour's drive northwest of Macon. And he has some Southern Conference experience. He was a longtime assistant in two different stints at Furman.
And not only that, you know, Coach Drew brings a lot of kind of the old school mentality. He wants to create great habits with this program. He understands that these are tough kids, great kids, and they're instilling those type of values on and off the field. He's a great guy. Had a great time getting to know him a little bit this week.
47-6 before arriving here, and he will win big, you just know it, with this Mercer program. Devin, they'll give him the 41-yard line on that first down carry. Told you, Tyree Devison, senior, within about 650 yards or so of their modern era career rushing record. T. Mitchell holds that. So with the SoCon 8-game schedule upcoming on the other side of the new year, a very good chance that Devizin, the Woodstock, Georgia native, out of Etowah High, will be the all-time career rushing leader here for the Mercer Bears. Marshall scored the touchdown moments ago, but that time Gibbons from behind able to knock him to the turf. And we did see a late flag coming in not far from where that tackle was made.
I'll tell you real quick on Gibbons. He's such a great sideline to sideline linebacker. He sees the ball, he gets there quickly. He shows up with bad intentions.
So Jerry Wellmaker indicating the face mask, and it's going to push the ball into Abilene Christian territory.
Yeah, I didn't quite see it on that particular angle, Pete, but again, you know, Jack Gibbons, he is a leader on this defensive unit. Again, both on and off the field, smart guy. He understands the game. He understands what the strategy is each and every week that this defense is trying to accomplish. You know, his responsibility is to communicate all the calls with all this different shifting and window dressing that you see. It's his responsibility to make sure that everyone's in the right position.
Devizin piled up once he gets inside of the 45.
You know, the thing about this Mercer offense too, Pete, you know, they're able to kind of work out the different wrinkles, you know, that they have right now. You know, they have a young offensive line. You know, they've got a lot of different players that are trying to understand a new offense. And the thing is, when you have three games in the fall to kind of work out the different errors and the issues, it sets you up at a good spot mentally as you get ready for conference play this spring.
Frost flags. I think it's going to be defensive pass interference, but boy, that was a tangled up situation. Pedro Rodriguez, tight end for the Bears. He got hung up with, it appeared, Anthony Godfrey, a safety. And it will be a defensive pass interference call. I really wasn't sure if they might not get Rodriguez on that.
It kind of could have went either way if you think about it. If you look at it right here, well, he did push on it in the back early now that we have the replay. But you don't want to give this offense free yards like that. You know, this offense, they have a lot of weapons, and they're showcasing that so far in this first half. They don't need any extra help.
Austin Godfrey, the penalty. Ooh. Look at the leap by Johnson, but good read that time defensively, and stepping up was the safety, Shelby Washington.
And again, Jack Gibbons, again, we're going to be saying his name all afternoon. He creates that penetration on the edge, forces the receiver to have to now jump, get in the air, and then the safety comes in to help clean everything up. When you have one thing about defense, and I've been around defensive guys all my life, they'll tell you, you have to pursue the football. You have to run to the football, do a lot of gang tackling, getting guys on the ground together, because when you have that type of mentality on the defense, it makes everything so much easier.
Second down, and nowhere to go that time for Devizin.
Look at all the white jerseys around the pile as they're getting Devizin down. Again, Devizin's not a little guy. You know, it takes a community to kind of bring this guy down. But they're doing a fantastic job, and now look at the sticks. We've got third and long, putting this offense into position where they have to throw it and allowing their Abilene Christian's defense to kind of pin their ears back and get after the quarterback.
Bears are a perfect 5 of 5 this afternoon on third down tries.
Here comes the shift. Don't get confused by all the shifting. Just play your responsibility.
Frost, man in stride, and a nice connection. Going to be well shy, though, of the first down marker is Ty James on the receiving end.
And right here, you see the defense keeping everything in front of them. The defense ran the zone, trying to make sure they don't get beaten deep, put everybody at the sticks and make the tackle in front of them and create a fourth down. And now, you know, hopefully holding them to only 3 points instead of giving them a touchdown.
Caleb Dowden, it'll be a try of 44 yards. 1 for 2 on the season, made a 36-yarder. Against Army, his career long is 45. That one has the distance, and it's good. And the Bears take their first lead of the game at 10-7.
Timeout on the field, media.
Bears able to get some points for the second time this quarter. They have a 10-7 lead. Ingalls College football here in Macon, Georgia. The Mercer Bears their first lead of the afternoon on Abilene Christian, a 10-7 advantage on the Caleb Dowden 44-yard field goal. Now they're kickoff specialist Devin Folser about to put his foot to the ball. Bears trying for their first win of the season. This is their third game. Abilene Christian coming in at 0-3. They're playing seven contests this fall, the Southland Conference Wildcats. And it'll go as a touchback. And on the kneel down, so it'll be first and 10 from the 25. Adam Dorrell now in his fourth season trying to build a program that went D1 back around 2013. He did an amazing job at his prior stop at his alma mater, Northwest Missouri Division II Power. He went 76-8 there, Jared, in 6 years.
Yeah, and the thing that he brings to this, you know, Abilene Christian program is creating, you know, all the right habits and focusing on core values. You know, they, one thing they preach to their guys is all about being selfless, about being tough, and being disciplined. And those are kind of their three main pillars of what they want to build this program and what the identity of this team needs to be moving forward.
Mansell through the hands of Dobbins, and right there was Richie Coffey in case a completion had been made. You know, we just saw Jordan Brooks West, another playmaker at wide receiver for this Abilene Christian offense, on the kneel down of the touchback. Haven't seen him, though, from scrimmage yet. You wonder if they're going to try to work him in to the game plan a little bit more. As it brings up second down and 10, he's not on the field right now.
Yeah, and again, you know, one thing we asked Coach about this week was who's going to help Kobe Clark? Who's going to be that extra receiver that's really going to make a difference, as we see Clark here making a catch and creating a third down and short. Came down kind of awkwardly, but he looks like he's up and he's okay.
Mansell able to keep his feet as he stumbled on the rollout. Adam Dorrell was an offensive lineman. His offensive coordinator was a great quarterback on a Division II title team when Dorrell was an assistant, Josh Lamberson. But they, you get the impression, work in unison to run this Abilene Christian attack. Trying to convert a third down for the third time in five tries today. And the handoff, Dobbins. And it'll be first and 10 for the Wildcats, as we're at 5 minutes to go before the half.
And that's just simply a nice inside zone play. You know, Dobbins, he has such great vision as a freshman to be able to understand and see the blocks and allow the big fellas to kind of get to their positions on that zone read and to get the first down. And again, Abilene Christian wants to, you know, convert big on these third downs to kind of sustain these drives. Third and two, you've got to make sure you get that. And Dobbins did a great job of keeping this drive alive.
Mansell, pressure comes, and he's taken down. A delayed blitz that time, scramble for the football. I believe Abilene Christian's going to keep it. Wow, fired out of the cannon. There's the freshman we talked about, Isaac Dowling, and that's how you make an early impression in your college career.
I tell you, he came and he delivered the boom right there on that big sack, and he almost recovered the fumble. I thought he did get it, but you see the high motor, you see the energy. You know, they kind of left him unblocked on the bootleg, which I'm surprised. You can't leave a guy like that, that has that kind of speed and that kind of ability to close down on the ball carrier. You can't allow him to go unblocked. Very risky play right there by Abilene Christian.
Fourth sack, fourth tackle for loss this season so far for Isaac Dowling, the standout freshman. Here's Dobbins on second and long, trying to get some of the yards back. And it'll bring up another third down for ACU. Winding down here in the second quarter, coming up, Cox halftime. A Southern Conference spring football preview that's going to get going in February, and we'll give a look at the Bears schedule. DeAndre Johnson, what an electric player he is, both offensively and on special teams for the Bears. We'll get to know him a little bit more and recap what has been a very competitive opening half between two teams getting together for the first time here in Macon. This day considered a celebration of football at Mercer. So happy they could play some in the fall. And Clark, nearly a leaping grab. Downfield, it'll bring up fourth down once more for Abilene Christian.
Great protection actually right there by the offensive line to kind of give the quarterback some time to look and see downfield. You know, you don't normally see drops like this from Kobe Clark. You know, he's being one of their big impact players. Very surprised he dropped that that pass right there. But good job by this Mercer defense, bend but don't break kind of mentality, forcing them to punt, and now they get the ball back, and hopefully they can put together a two-minute drive to get points on the board before the half.
Burke, second punt for him today. That's better than the one he kicked earlier from the rugby look. And it'll go out of bounds. Landon Miller again back for the Bears, but never had a chance to return it. And once again, the Mercer defense stepping up. They came into the ball game, of course, off that lopsided loss last week at Army, but well, the Black Knights will do that to you. But defense that has been growing. We've seen them do a lot of things. That delayed blitz by Dowling that led to the big defensive play on that last series, an example of that. But here they go on offense, trying to build on this 10-7 advantage.
Great opportunity right here again. Can they put together some points in a two-minute drive and go the length of the field?
Handoff goes left side and trying to churn his way ahead, Marshall.
And these are things, again, Pete, that you can work on before you get ready for the spring play, the spring conference play. You know, you've got 2 minutes on the clock. You've got all three timeouts. Can we put together a drive and get points out of it? Great practice right here against a very worthy opponent. You've been practicing all week long and you know, limited throughout the fall. But can you actually showcase that and get some good game film, which you can use as teaching points as you get ready for conference play?
Crossed on second down, Marshall. Oh. A little bit behind him.
It was, but it touched his hands. You know, if you touch your hands, you got to catch it. You know, but he did a great job kind of slipping out the backfield. Would have been a huge play for this offense and put them in great position. But it stops the clock, creates third and long. If you're Abilene Christian, can you kind of pin your ears back, apply pressure, and get the ball back for your offense for a possible two-minute drill?
And important, as you mentioned, stopping the clock. Abilene Christian, two timeouts to use before the half. But a chance to get the ball back before the intermission with some time to work. Frost, not so sure that was a designed run. And we will see the punting unit for the Bears.
What do we see right there? Great penetration off the edge, and it forced him to have to make a turn back to the line of scrimmage that he did not want to do. If you want to stop this running up game of Mercer, you're going to have to create a new line of scrimmage. You're going to have your defensive lineman push that offensive line back, create penetration, and force them to get out of their running zones. Great job by Abilene Christian's defensive unit of getting off the field. And again, 2 minutes left. They've got two timeouts. I don't see why they can't try to go down the field and get points on the board before the half.
And as you saw, Adam Dorrell using one of those two remaining timeouts here in the opening half. So the Bears defense that's done a nice job forcing a turnover that led to a score and forcing the Wildcats to punt the last couple of times they've had the ball. Drew Cronick hoping he can get another stop and take a lead into halftime. His first home game as a head coach here at Mercer, and you know that meant something extra to him. Just about anyone involved in football, whether you're on the field or here in the booth, just happy to be able to play games this fall.
Pete, I'm just so happy to be here with you in the booth. I mean, I don't know if I could have waited to the springtime to be in the booth with you. Now we're back
here
together.
We are.
The world is almost whole now, you know?
That's a beautiful thing. So out of the timeout, 2:05 to go. You got a little too gushy there on me,
I'm
big
sorry.
Man.
I'm sorry, Pete. You know, didn't know this day was going to happen.
Grant Goupil, first time today. He'll kick it away, and a good one. Brooks West off the bobble. And he'll go down just shy of the 30-yard line. We noted earlier this is considered a celebration of football here at Mercer. They not only wanted to play as many games as they could this fall, but also have at least one home game so that their student body and their local fan base could come out to Five Star Stadium. They normally are right at full capacity in normal times here in this beautiful facility. Obviously, they're spacing folks out, doing a great job as a program. They've been above and beyond, as Jim Cole, their athletic director, noted in our pregame show. They've been using FBS level protocols. And here they are playing their third and final game of the fall. Pressure comes again.
Wow.
And another sack by the Bears. That one came right up the middle.
I mean, he came right up the gut. You know, one thing about it, this Abilene Christian, one of their opportunity points this year is the offensive line, pass pro. Can they protect their you know, this Iowa transfer quarterback to give him an opportunity to showcase his skills? It's really important, especially in a two-minute drill. You can't give up a sack because it forces you to have to call a timeout, which they're having to do, and create second and long, which is a really tough position to put your offense in.
Chris Hill, the redshirt freshman out of Statesboro, you saw him with his second sack so far this season. They'll put some more time back on the game clock as the Bears now taking advantage of the fact that that was a sack that led to a loss of 7 yards and a chance now with two timeouts remaining in the half to conserve some clock and have a chance to add to this three-point lead.
And again, this defense, you know, for Mercer, you know, they have an opportunity to create that kind of pressure. They understand it's passing down. When you have that as a defensive lineman, you know, you're told right there, watch the ball, be smart, but get after the quarterback. You know, understand what, you know, you've been looking at film all week long. You understand how this offensive lineman likes to pass set, whether he's heavy on the inside or sometimes if he gets overextended on his kickbacks. Can this defensive line create more pressure on this quarterback and get out of the half, you know, with the lead?
Peyton Mansell, unique about him, he is married. His wife, Sydney, in fact, a softball player who played at Abilene Christian. She now plays at Baylor. But he is a guy that has come in here and trying to make this offense go with players around him like L.J. McConnell. It was his big near 60-yard play that set up their first touchdown. McConnell gets a lot of those lost yards back.
He does.
Bring up third down.
He does right there. Creates a more third and manageable. Surprised he didn't go out of bounds right there to kind of stop the clock.
Another timeout is called, I believe. At least the officials have stopped the clock with 1:33 to go. And in that case, that may have been a situation with the play clock. And now play stopped again. Indeed,
timeout.
We will have a timeout called by the Bears. Timeout. As Abilene Christian gets ready for a third down and 5. Wildcats so far 3 out of 6 on third down tries. And as they're approaching midfield, if they get a first down here, they've got to start seeing that end zone or at least try to get within the range of their place kicker, Blair Zepeda.
And the thing is, this Abilene Christian offense, they have weapons. You know, you look at Kobe Clark, you look at L.J. McConnell, you know, Tay Williams. You know, they have the guys that can take the top off of a defense if needed, but that offensive line has got to protect. If you don't give the quarterback any time, it doesn't matter how many athletes you have, they're not going to get the ball because your quarterback is picking himself up off the ground. So can this offensive line in this two-minute drill, can they give their quarterback enough time to make a play?
You see Adam Dorrell, the head coach of Abilene Christian in the middle, he said something very interesting to us. He used the time in the spring when everything was shut down out in Texas like it was all over the country to, on a daily basis over about a 2-year span, just evaluate everything about his program. They really didn't have spring football like so many others around the country, but he really took a look inside of what he was doing going into his 4th year. They had a winning season, their first in D1 a couple of years ago. Were a couple of games under 500 last year, picked in the middle of the pack in the 9-team Southland Conference going into this year before they realized they weren't going to have a normal conference season like everybody else. And just kind of evaluating where things are in the 4th year. He had won so much on the D2 level, both as an assistant and then as the head coach of his alma mater, Northwest Missouri, that he's adjusting to a new level just like the new players he brings into his program.
Well, I think, you know, throughout this whole COVID-19 pandemic, you know, coaches, people in general have learned a lot about themselves and have had the time and opportunity to really find ways to grow, whether it's personally or professionally. And the fact that he's been able to admit that, I think that's very important. As we seem to get some type of explanation from the head guy.
Yeah, Jerry Wellmaker, our referee, and Doral, apparently looking to get an answer. And he'll call his ACU team back around him. I don't know if he's using his final timeout of the half. I don't believe that's the case.
It's been the longest minute, 25 seconds I've ever experienced.
It might be confusion on the spot. We are told it's 3rd down and 5. I'm coming now. Jerry Wellmaker giving Drew Kronick the explanation apparently that he was looking for, and the Mercer head coach appears to be satisfied with whatever the referee just told him. We've not been given the indication that an actual timeout was called, but perhaps The scoreboard showing us each team with one timeout remaining. So our referee may be heading in the area of being able to get on the headphones, and that's exactly what he's doing. So Jerry Wellmaker wants to go up to the replay booth and get clarity, perhaps on the spot of the ball. And maybe it's not third down and five. I believe the complaint from ACU, if I read this properly, is they think it's third down a little bit shorter after McConnell picked up 12 yards on that last play.
And it makes a difference, you know, because when you have 12, you know, third down and short compared to third down and medium or long, it changes up your strategy. You know, it changes up what you're going to do, what kind of plays you're going to call. But again, being in a two-minute offense, you kind of want everything quick as possible to kind of get your offense down the field, to set them up, set your team up for field goal, within field goal range. So hopefully that's what, you know, the conversations are right now in these two huddles.
On a cool, crisp fall day, perfect football kind of day. Overcast now, but we've seen sunshine throughout. Abilene Christian had a very interesting experience at practice on Monday night. They practice on Mondays at nighttime because of the schedules.
Yeah.
And they actually had a brief snowstorm. They had some crazy weather in West Texas. Let's get an explanation from our referee.
30.
If I can read his lips correctly.
I hope you can, because I didn't take that class.
It was a timing issue, not a ball placement issue. So the clock had shown us 125, and they're resetting the game clock to 134. But in West Texas, out in Abilene, where they're located about a 2.5-hour drive of the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex right off I-20. They're not used to getting snow, and really freezing rain or sleet is rare. But as they went out to practice on Monday night, they had some sleet. Then all of a sudden, about 15 minutes of what he said was a blizzard. And his guys, who aren't used to seeing snow, he said they were loving every minute of it. Here's Adam Dorrell, who grew up in Missouri and played up there. And he's like, I'm from up north. You get tired of this in a hurry.
I practiced in the snow one time in my career. It's not that fun for me personally.
Mansell dumping. And left well shy of the first down marker is McConnell. Good job out on the flat. Richie Coffee and Isaac Dowling have been all over the place in this opening half of that Bears defense.
You know, we talked about this, Pete. You know, the thing about Isaac Dowling, because of his energy, because of his high motor, it's contagious. It makes everyone else want to kind of raise their standard of play. And great job by this defensive unit of shutting them down on third down, creating fourth and medium. And hopefully getting the ball back with about a minute 30 for their offense to maybe put something together.
Let's give credit to LaDerrick Johnson, the corner, also in on that stop. And so now the Bears indeed have used their final time out of the half with 1:28 to go before the break. And for a third time this afternoon, we will see the Abilene Christian punter, Logan Burke. The flags atop the stands across the field from our position behind the Mercer bench, blowing pretty steadily from the TV camera perspective side away, so going across, and from the perspective of the punter, Burke, from his right to left.
I wouldn't be surprised if Mercer really tried to go after Abilene Christian here on this punt, go all out for an all-out block to kind of create that momentum late here in the second quarter.
Landon Miller again back deep. And pressure comes. Burke just gets it away. No rugby style that time. Fair catch called for. And Miller just shy of the 40-yard line.
They've got good position, Pete. You know, being on the 34, 35-yard line, and, you know, they don't have any timeouts left. You know, they can put something together rather quickly here. I think they may be able to come out with at least a field goal.
Each of these teams scoring a touchdown after the opponent fumbled. Those fumbles happening in the opening quarter. ACU took a 7-0 lead into quarter number two, but that was short-lived because the Bears capped off the drive with the end around to Marshall on a 13-yard run to tie us earlier in the second. This time it's Fred Davis. Good job by the Wildcats that time.
Great penetration off the edge again. forcing him having to slow down and giving the opportunity for your other defensive unit to come and gang tackle him down. That's what it's going to take for this Abilene Christian defense, especially here in the second half. You kind of understand what the game plan is for this Mercer offense and how to slow it down.
Frost firing long, Johnson leaping. What a grab, DeAndre Johnson. Brian Bullock, the Northwestern transfer, did everything he could to defend, but that is a beautiful catch, and the Bears are in business.
Johnson did a great job kind of climbing the ladder on that one to go get that football. Here you see him playing with a little tempo, going fast. We've got less than a minute to go. Can they get a touchdown before the half?
Clock stopping briefly so they can reset the chains. In the red zone again, Devison.
Got
up inside of the 10 after that 48-yard connection from Frost to Johnson.
They've got to hurry up here. They got to play with tempo. You don't have any timeouts. 30 seconds left. Can you get a touchdown?
Under half a minute to go before the break. And again, the Bears out of timeouts, but not clocking it. Frost firing. Grab. Oh. Incomplete. For a moment, it was in the hands of the intended target, Ty James, but good coverage by the cornerback on the play for Abilene Christian.
Great job right here by the defender, staying with the receiver the whole time. I thought he was going to come down with it, Pete, but great coverage right there by the Abilene Christian defense. But it's not a problem. Third down, it stops the clock, allows everyone to catch their breath, call the right play that's going to give your unit opportunity to get the first down or get a touchdown before the half.
Tristan Anderson, you see him there, his second pass broken up on the year. Now, to the benefit of the Bears, it does stop the clock with 20 seconds to go. Third down. Frost look toward the end zone, dumping it. Marshall, no room to run, squirts away briefly. And now they're going to run the field goal unit out there. Clock continues to wind. Going to be tough to get it set up. You see the final seconds. Dowden and the snap. Let's see if they got it away in time. And it would have proved to be a non-attempt anyway, and that's how we arrive at halftime. So we didn't see either team score. We saw one heck of a toss from Frost to Johnson, and that's how we arrive at halftime. A frenetic final seconds of our opening half of play, and the Mercer Bears, their lone home game of the fall, will take a three-point lead into the halftime locker room. Mercer trying for a first win in their third game so far in this fall season. First ever meeting against Abilene Christian. Out of the Southland Conference, Drew Cronick, his first home game. Much anticipated for the first year head coach of the Bears. Kristen Banks on the sidelines. We'll visit with Coach Cronick. Kristen.
Yes, sir. Coach Cronick, earlier you mentioned that you go into the half and you tell your team this is why we're winning and this is what we need to keep doing. What are you going to tell them today?
Well, I think we're playing hard. Obviously, we got two evenly matched teams. We just got to play better. I probably put my kids in a bad situation right there, but we got to be smarter with the football. And we got to stop turning the ball. We had two turnovers early. We got rid of that. Then they had a couple turnovers, kind of even back out. So we just got to go play. Let's go play as hard as we can.
Yes, sir. Good luck in the second half, and thank you so much.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
Both Mercer and Abilene Christian hungry for a win this fall. They're trying for their first. Brandon Marshall getting into the end zone for the Bears in an opening half in which they saw a 7-0 deficit go away. It's halftime here in Macon. Three-point game as our second half is set to begin. Evan Folser about to kick it away. Bears team trying to get a victory for the Southern Conference during the fall. No SoCon wins registered so far, with the Citadel, Chattanooga, Mercer, and Western Carolina all competing in the fall months. Western Carolina has yet to play. Chattanooga almost picked up a second game this season. They had an opportunity to perhaps play at Nebraska because Nebraska's game against Wisconsin was called off, but the Big Ten would not allow that, so Chattanooga's playing just once. Western will play three times. The Citadel has already played four times and received an NCAA waiver this week to be able to compete for the SoCon title, playing a total of 12 games in the 2021 campaign. Brooks West watches that one go out of the end zone. Let's go downstairs to Kristen Banks, who had a chance to visit with Adam Dorrell, the head coach of ACU.
Thanks, guys. I just talked with Adam Dorrell, and he said he's very happy with his team only having one turnover but causing two. But he said offensively, first downs are killing them, and that in the second half, they need to work on converting yardage in the first half. And then on defense, they're really focused on stopping Mercer's outside jet sweep. Back to you guys.
And a credit to Joel Taylor and the defensive staff at Mercer. Adam Dorrell's team looked like they had really good flow for the better part of their game last week, that overtime loss against Stephen F. Austin. We have not seen that for the most part today. They start on the ground. We've seen more of Jeremiah Dobbins than we have of Tyrese White. And the first carry of the second half again goes to Dobbins, who's picked up their lone touchdown of the ball game so far.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised by that because, you know, Tyrese White, you know, he ran for two touchdowns last week. Thought we'd get a big dose of him. But Dobbins is just as good. You know, I think he brings a lot of energy as a young guy. You know, he has good vision. So it'll be interesting to see how they kind of balance that out here in the second half.
Not sure if there was an injury issue with White trying to find him on the sideline. Mansell nearly intercepted. Boy. Lance Wise wishes he were about a foot closer to the line of scrimmage that time.
You know, I've never played quarterback, Pete, but I've heard that it's not good to throw back across the field like that, especially across your body. You know, I'm not really sure what he was trying to do here because he almost had that turned over, and that's not something you want to do. Now you create third and long, put yourself in position for this Mercer defense to kind of pin their ears back and get after the quarterback.
Third downs in the game, 3 of 7 for ACU. Late pressure comes over the middle, Clark. And it's Wise who brings him down near midfield. Well, he's their big playmaker when they needed it most. They were able to connect.
Yeah, he does a great job underthrowing ball. Kobe Clark does a fantastic job of coming back to the ball and adjusting to the, you know, the poorly thrown ball that we saw right there. However, Kobe Clark, you know, he had 8 touches so far in the first half. Coming and getting him started early in the second half is really important. They wanted to get him the ball as much as possible because he's one of their playmakers on offense.
22 yards, his 5th catch of the game after he had 6 last week. Here is White, first time in a while. He is stonewalled as he makes the turn.
Little misdirection play right here, kind of jet sweep to the right, pitch back to the left. Wasn't able to get as much on that first down play as you want to, but it's good to see him back in the game, and hopefully he has a bigger role here in the second half.
Solomon Zabaro among those leading the surge for the Bears. It'll go as a gain of 1. Mansell toward the sideline. Will be caught by the rangy wide receiver Dax Neese, the Texas Tech transfer.
That's the thing, Pete. They have a lot of transfers on this team. Guys that, you know, have played at the big stage. They can make plays. The key is just getting them the ball. You know, can this offensive line, you know, hold up and give enough time for this quarterback to make the throws needed to get this offense moving in the right direction?
4 of their wide receivers, and most of them key players, are transfers from other FBS programs. And we've been getting used to the quarterback who transferred in from a Power 5 program in Iowa, Mansell. He'll hand Brooks West. Have not seen him touch the ball on a snap and almost able to break away from Michael Campbell that time, who made potentially a touchdown saving tackle.
Now we're starting to see the balance of this Abilene Christian offense. You know, you see the stretch plays to Kobe. Then you see, you know, some of the inside runs with Tyrese White and Jeremiah Dobbins. And now you're seeing the misdirection, kind of the jet sweep. This is an offense that, like you said, they have a lot of transfers, guys that have played at the highest level. Can they kind of get them the ball? But it's all going to start with that offensive line. Can they protect?
Looking to dump it back and wisely throwing it at the feet. He did have his tight end and one of his best friends, Remington Luce, right in front of him. That's why we won't see a flag for grounding.
Yeah, and again, it goes back to what I just said. I literally just said the offensive line has got to do a better job of pass protection. And when you give a quarterback, you know, like Peyton Manziel time, he's going to make the right throw.
He wasn't out of the pocket, but again, a tight end who looked like he was in pass protect right there was in the area of the ball. He was an eligible receiver, so it'll bring up 2nd down and 10. Smart move that time by Mansell to avoid lost yards. Dobbins trying to find room, stood up at the line of scrimmage. Nice job.
Yeah, great job right there by this Mercer defense. As you again, you're seeing them swarm to the football as well because they understand, you know, the kind of threat that Dobbins and White, what kind of threat they create on the run game. But here we go, third and long, the first third and long that we're really seeing in the second half. Can Peyton Manziel muster up enough offense right here on this play to keep this drive alive? I would not be surprised if they run some kind of naked boot to kind of get him to move outside the pocket so he can see the field and take some of that pressure off the offensive line.
Slip screen, Clark, and he'll come up about a yard or two shy. It'll be Clark, an effective weapon so far. You can see the frustration. He thought he could lunge a few yards more and pick up another first down.
Yeah, he had that huge play earlier in this drive, and that was the third time that they were able to give him the football on this drive. Again, he is the best player on this offensive unit. They want to give him the football as much as they can, because when he has the ball and he has space, he's able to make a lot of things happen. But hopefully they can get three on the board and tie this game up.
Blair Zepeda, first opportunity today, 4 out of 5 on the season. 41 yards. Wynn moving across, and it's good. And we're tied, this time at 10 apiece. Each place kicker able to convert so far. The Bears and the Wildcats here in the third quarter. It's Ingles College Football in Macon. And Kristen Banks, Pete Gannady with you back at Five Star Stadium here in Macon, Georgia. The sun has peeked back through the clouds this last afternoon in daylight saving time before we turn the clocks back tonight. And a scoring drive for Abilene Christian that covered 76 yards in 10 plays and ended up with that field goal from 41 yards away to tie us up at 10-10.
It looked like in that last drive with Abilene Christian, they were more balanced. They felt a little like the nerves were kind of calmed down. And we saw different things of their offense. You know, they kind of, you know, went deep with a big pass to Kobe Clark down the field. You know, they were able to get, you know, some of their run game with Dobbins and White kind of established as well. And they came off with 3 points to tie this game up. So hopefully this defense can kind of slow down this Mercer offense and get the ball back to their this Abilene Christian offense, which seems to be kind of settling down in this game.
Short kick and the fair catch as Abilene Christian, with the win not to their advantage that time, wanted nothing to do with DeAndre Johnson potentially getting his hands on the ball. So the Bears will begin at their own 29-yard line as they run the offense out there for the first time in the second half. Harrison Frost, we talked about at the half, a very steady opening 30 minutes of play.
Just doing what he's supposed to do, taking care of the football, getting the ball to his playmakers, making the right calls, making all the right adjustments, just being a great game manager. You see more of the shifting going on, that window dressing, and then coming back with the basic power right up the middle and getting a good, you know, 4 or 5 yards on first down. I'm very impressed with what this young man has been able to do. And again, he's doing everything that his team needs him to do at this point of the season.
Marshall, the slot back. Jared, I have never seen a team's offensive line shift so often during the course of a game as we see in Mercer.
Yeah, and I think that's, you know, part of this new age of you know, all these different shifts and different wrinkles that people are doing with offenses. I mean, it's the same simple basic play. It's just adding a new wrinkle to make you think. And when you can add that one wrinkle, that one thing that looks different, it can cause a little bit of hesitation from the defense. And that's that little hesitation is all you need, you know, to make big plays. But as you see here, just rolling out, making a smart throw and utilizing these different weapons that he has at his disposal.
Second catch of the day for Steven Peterson, 14 yards on the play. Looked like a little bit of confusion off the handoff. Another end around for the Bears. And Brandon Mays, positive yards though in the crowded area.
And again, you know, here you see the jet sweep motion going and a simple handoff. I mean, such a basic play, but it's so effective because you have all the different window dressing. And as a defense, you know, defense is all about reacting. When you see all these different moving parts, it can create hesitation, especially for a new and young defense that's not used to seeing this.
Hunter Keir knocking him out of bounds. Second down, ball on the ground, and Frost will simply recover. That's the last thing that Drew Kronick wanted to see. Would have been a third fumble loss so far in the game.
Yeah, and it looked like it was another good misdirection play. Just, you know, good handoff or good exchange from the center. He just kind of fumbled that one once he got into his drop. But here we go, third and medium. You know, what play are you going to call? If you can get it to fourth and short, then the question is, do you just go for it? Because you've been able to get a lot of success from your run game.
Bears began the day 5 of 5 on third downs. They're 5 out of 8. Frost, the connection. And pushed out of bounds is Ty James, but enough for the first down.
I tell you, this Frost kid, he's just doing all the little things right. He gets the ball, he understands he just fumbled it, made a mistake. But what does he do? He comes right back with a lot of confidence. They move the pocket out so he can see the defense, get set up, allow his guys to get to the sticks, and makes a great first down throw to keep the drive alive. Fantastic job by this young man. And again, he's doing a great job of managing the assets that he has on this offensive unit.
Again, shifting offensive lineman, Trey Iorillo among those on the move to the right side from the left. And Devison that time with the power. And they've spread it around enough so far in this half on the boundary that then again they come at you with the human bowling ball in Devison.
I mean, you have to take your pick. You know, what do you want to stop? You can't stop everything. You know, if you want to stop the jet sweep, fine. But then that's going to, you know, allow your inside, you know, interior defense to be at the mercy of a guy like who they call the bowling ball to knock you over. So I think this Mercer offense right now, they're hitting on all cylinders and they're utilizing all the different resources that they have because they definitely have a lot of athletes right here on this offensive unit.
Marshall again, an outside in play.
But the key also to this, Pete, is you get so sucked into, you know, the power and then the quick, you know, handoff on the jet sweep. All of those things kind of build up to the play action down the field. And so that's going to be interesting to see as they progress, get ready for the spring season. You know, being able to open up for these wide receivers off of those different play actions and who's going to get the, who's going to be able to take the top off of a defense for this offensive unit. That's what's going to come from all this good ability, the good job of being able to run the football effectively.
Good hard run that time. Tyree Devison, he was fourth in the SoCon in rushing a year ago. And the power package, pretty much the one-man power package that time as he dragged the defender. I believe that was Gibbons in on the stop for Abilene Christian. So a first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Frost over the middle, has a man, and Zach Davis, the freshman. And the touchdown for the Clover South Carolina native, and the Bears move back in front.
Great job, great pass pro right there by that offensive line of Mercer, creating a nice pocket for Frost. And then just, again, when you have driven the football by running the football very effectively, it opens up a lot of these passing opportunities. And right there we saw it with a great opportunity and obviously 6 on the board.
Harrison Frost executing that beautifully. Zach Davis, the freshman, is the down and extra point is good. And in his first career home game, Zach Davis able to come through with his first career touchdown reception. On the toss, 30 yards on the play. Mercer back up. What a thrill for freshman wide receiver Zach Davis. Here you see him getting some congratulations on the sideline. His first career touchdown reception, played for his high school coach Brian Lane in Clover, South Carolina, in a wide open offense in high school. Now the true freshman, his first TD reception, wearing the orange and black of the Mercer Bears. And this Abilene Christian team playing this season with heavy hearts. Their teammate and a dynamic player for them, Samaje Davis, continues to recover in his battle coming back from a serious car accident in early October. He is in a hospital in Fort Worth, Texas. Samaje Davis would have played some quarterback, a lot of wide receiver, would have been a real slash, and they are thinking of him each and every day they hit the practice field and the games they play. They have their teammate first and foremost in their minds. We hope he and his family are able to tune in today, and we are told he continues to battle on the Abilene Christian Athletic websites. The family has done a nice job giving updates on Samaje and his recovery from very serious injuries, but certainly our best going to Samaje Davis and his family. Kick is away. Mercer uses Devin Folser as a kickoff specialist. Looks like Brooke West is going to return it, and he is hit and taken down to the 10-yard line. Great job on the coverage team that time. Bears trying to win in special teams, and it was a nice stop on the play by Devon McKinney. Now Lionel McConnell, who goes by LJ, switched from number one this week to number four, and that's to honor his not only teammate, but his roommate, Samaje Davis.
Yeah, it's things like that that make football so special. You know, you have guys, someone on your team that goes down in such a tragedy, and you have your other, you know, teammates around you kind of, you know, doing things like, you know, representing him via his jersey when they went to go visit some of his family when they were in the area of, you know, in Texas. It's just little things like that that make a difference and that makes college football and being on a team such a special thing.
As you see, and Abilene Christian player for the second time of the game. They have a player down with an injury on a kickoff. In this case, it's on their kickoff return team. Earlier it was on kickoff coverage. And the athletic training staff having a course during this pandemic to operate in a different way than they were accustomed. So Adam Dorrell, he has seen his team fall behind by 3 points in this game and now by 7 points, and he'll try to get things figured out. As Abilene Christian playing their fourth game of the fall. Take a look at the bottom right corner of your screen as we look at the return by Jordan Brooks West. Thought for a moment he was going to take a knee. I think the hesitation is what led to the fact that McKinney was able to take him down where he did, but you saw the hard contact and trying to determine if that is the number 8 of Daniel Dua, one of their wide receivers, or if it's the number 9 of one of their linebackers who likely would have been in on special teams coverage, Chike Wankwo.
You know, they make the jersey so tight now. You know, I didn't have that problem back then. My jersey was still a little tight.
I was going to say, I don't know if they could have added the seamstress talons to get enough thread to expand it. Well, looks like the injured player is going to be okay. And on a 1st and 10 from deep in their own territory, they keep it on the ground. And by the way, the player who walked off has gone on the 10, so we're not sure which one it was. But back to work goes Abilene Christian, trying to get back a little bit closer in this game or tie it.
And, you know, on that last possession, you know, there was a lot of different things that were positive. They were able to, you know, kind of get Kobe Clark involved early. They had a little misdirection. They had some strong runs up the middle. Can they put it all together now to kind of get a touchdown at the end of the drive? That's going to be the big question here.
6 yards on the Dobbins run. There's McConnell, a little out across the 20, knocked out of bounds, but he gets the first down.
Yeah, great throw. And that's what they want to do. They want to create these short throws that are, you know, allow Peyton to be comfortable in the pocket. And he doesn't have to hold the ball too long, because this offensive line, they've struggled in the pass pro area. And so they don't want him to have those long drop backs where he's having to hold the ball for 3 to 4 or 5 seconds. Get the ball out quick and create a lot of balance on this offensive unit.
1st and 10. Mansell, we've seen him roll and throw both ways. A hard pass that time to Clark, who pulled in the bullet just a few yards upfield. And we'll bring up 2nd down.
You know, looking at this replay, Pete, sometimes, you know, if there's no one to throw to, throwing back against the grain like that is not always the smartest play. So, you know, I think one thing they would like to see Peyton do is kind of just get rid of the ball, you know, and live to play another down. Throwing it back against the grain like that, you have the risk of the ball getting tipped. You look at the risk of the ball getting intercepted, and you just want to try to limit those turnovers as much as possible.
This time he rolls left for McConnell, and that'll go for another 1st down. So Mansell, before the snap, as often we see the quarterbacks with a play chart on their forearm or on their wrist area. We also saw McConnell, a wide out, looking at his. That basically is a sequence of, I guess, numbers or plays that correspond with numbers?
So, yeah, I mean, a lot of times you'll have a, you know, coach on the sideline or different coaches based on skill position, you know, give a certain number, give a certain, you know, code. I think they have something on the sideline here they're holding up that shows different numbers. And that tells every position what the play is and what their responsibilities are and keeps everyone on the same page.
McConnell underneath, looks for room. L.J. McConnell had that huge play on their opening drive that set up the touchdown. You can tell he's a guy you don't want to see get in space, just like Clark.
Yeah, he complements Clark really well. And these are two guys that they're going to have a huge second half if Abilene Christian is going to have a chance to come back in this game. And again, it all starts with the big guys up front. You know, the big guys have to give Peyton enough time to feel comfortable in that pocket to step up and make those throws, because right now they're having to move him out the pocket on these different boots and these different plays that get him outside the pocket so he can make these type of throws. And now, as you see here, this Mercer defense is coming downhill, hitting guys hard at the line of scrimmage and creating that third and five, which is, again, a tough spot to be in, but you have to
hit that time, came into the ball game with a dozen tackles. Probably the hardest contact he's had so far here in game number three as he took White down. So third down and three. So far in the game, Wildcats 3 of 8 on third down tries.
Big third down right here, Pete. They've got to convert this.
Time moving, coming up on 3 minutes to go. Brooks West, a first down and more as he gets out across midfield.
And a great job right there by West of understanding, okay, instead of going east-west, put his foot in the ground and get north-south. You know, once you kind of clear the line of scrimmage, right here, he puts his foot in the ground and gets north, get that first down. You see so many times with young guys, they want to keep stringing it out to the sideline, and a lot of times they don't make the first down because they string it out. Great job right there of sustaining the drive and keeping it alive, because again, this is a very critical down, a very critical drive as they're down 7 right now against Mercer.
Looking at how these teams each run things offensively, I think both will benefit from looking at the game film. They'll probably learn something from others. Nothing doing for McConnell on first down. Great job stretching it out by the defense. And who else leading the way but the true freshman Isaac Dowling?
Well, again, they're going to cut the film on and know number 46 very well, Isaac Dowling. And he's going to be a name that we're going to speak a lot of come this spring, because he's making a name for himself. He's going to be a rising star in this conference. He brings, like I said, a lot of energy. He's always around the football. You know, he's making plays, whether it's batting it down, creating sacks, trying to jump on fumbles. He is truly going to be a star, has a very bright future at Mercer.
Jordan Williams, a Citadel transfer, defensive end, was also in on that stop. Second down and long. This time it's Dobbins.
You know, Dobbins, he's a freshman as well. He's been getting a lot of the workload today as far as the run responsibilities are concerned. But here we go. You know, you got third and what, 6 or 7? Can they convert? I wouldn't be surprised if they try to, you know, do some kind of naked boot where the quarterback is, you know, he gets out of the pocket and he has different receivers that he can throw to on the run. He seems to do very well throwing on the run, but can he make the right decision and can one of his receivers get open to give them an opportunity for a first down?
Manziel, 13 of 18 by air so far for 153 yards. Looking to throw again. Nice open and another first down. Boy, it looked like for just a moment LaDerrick Johnson might get a hand on it in the secondary for the Bears, but the drive continues for the Wildcats.
Well, when you have a superstar like Kobe Clark, what he does is he forces that corner and that safety to have all eyes on him. And because of that, it allows others like this, you know, number 19, getting wide open and allowing him to make a play on third down. Great job, but a lot of that comes from two things. Great pass pro on that particular play, and the great impact that Kobe Clark has as far as sucking in other guys and creating opportunities for his teammates to get open and complete first downs.
A minute to go in our third quarter. This time on the end around, and Wise reading it beautifully as Darius Lewis had nowhere to go.
He had nowhere to go because that safety was flying. As soon as he sees that jet motion sweep, he takes off as well. And when you see that as a safety, you know that's what they were doing all day. Number 3 was not going to be denied on that tackle. He did a great job of reading it, coming from his deep safety position and making the play in the backfield, creating a second and long.
Boy, that really gets an Abilene Christian team, which had pretty much stayed on schedule in this drive. They had a second and 10 or two in there along the way, but that goes for some big lost yards, as much on the impact of the stop. And now with 15 seconds to go in the third quarter and a second down and 13 coming up, Adam Dorrell goes ahead and uses his first time out of the second half. We'll take one as well. 17 to 10 our score. Ingalls College Football. Jared, you and I did the Mercer at Wofford game a couple of years ago. That's where the Bears will begin their SoCon schedule this season on February 20th. An 8-game SoCon slate as per usual. First conference home game here at Five Star Stadium against the Citadel a week later on the 27th. Bears getting visits from the Bulldogs, Western Carolina, Furman, and the Bucks of ETSU. And if they can play the SoCon slate like they've competed today, they're going to do just fine in Drew Cronick's first season at the helm.
And I think, you know, getting this play in the fall, like we said in the open, Pete, you know, it gives them that understanding of where they are as a team. You know, what do they need to focus on going into the spring? And again, I think it benefits them giving these guys some real live game reps that you just can't, you know, get when you're in practice all the time. So I think this Mercer team, you see the balance on offense, you see the energy they play with on defense, obviously the weapons on special teams. You know, they're going to have a chance to make their mark within the SoCon and, you know, hopefully compete for a championship.
Lance Wise having himself some kind of game. Push White out of bounds after a pickup of 4. And that'll bring us to the end of quarter number 3. 15 minutes to go in the lone home game of the fall for the Mercer Bears. They own a 7-point lead on visiting Abilene Christian. A first ever meeting between the Bears from the SoCon and the Wildcats from the Southland. We come back with our fourth quarter on Ingalls College Football after this. Here's our game summary through 3 quarters. We anticipated a shootout between these two quarterbacks. For the most part, it's been that way. The yards not overwhelming for either, but both Peyton Mansell and Harrison Frost have been a big reason why this game is where it's at right now. A 17-10 Bears lead as our fourth quarter gets underway. How about Lance Wise, the safety for the Bears so far, career high 10 tackles for him. He has been all over the place. He and the Bears defense now getting ready to try to deny ACU and another third down try, our first snap of quarter number 4. Mansell has some time. Ooh. Dumps it inside. Nice job knocking it away by Dowling so he doesn't just make stops, the freshman.
He almost picked that off. And the thing about, you know, Peyton Mansell, he did a great job kind of rolling out, kind of letting letting his guys get in position. But I tell you what, I think he should have kind of tucked it and tried to pick up the first down with his legs. He has that ability. He's an athlete. But the good thing is, as you said, Wise is having a career day. He's doing a great job of kind of complimenting Isaac Dowell on this Mercer defense. But the thing is, Abilene Christian needs to put points on the board. Hopefully they can get it with this field goal, because the way Mercer's running the football, they may not get that many opportunities here in the fourth quarter.
Blair Zepeda missed a 45-yard try last week. That from 46, and it's no good. Pushed it out just a little bit. It had the distance, so just the second miss in 7 attempts this season for Blair Zepeda, the redshirt sophomore out of Richardson, Texas, and it remains a 17-10 game. The wind is blowing toward the right goalpost, and perhaps that played a factor in Zepeda just missing it wide right.
That's tough. And again, you don't want to leave points on the board, especially against such a well-balanced offense like Mercer. I would predict here, as we get the fourth quarter started, we're going to see a big dose of these backs, and all of them have had a pretty balanced game. With, you know, Devison with 41 yards, Marshall with 42 yards. Johnson and Davis also respectively with 32 and 27 yards. Everyone's been touching the football, and I wouldn't be surprised if we see that here in the fourth quarter.
Bears get it back first and 10. Marshall the inside handoff as they start this series from their own 29-yard line. And now, even though there's more than 14 minutes to go here in our fourth quarter of play, what we've seen is a tendency for Harrison Frost and this Bears offense becomes oh so important right now, especially from Abilene Christian's perspective in terms of trying to get the ball back.
Get the ball back and also protecting the football. If you're Harrison Frost right now, you want to make all the right reads. You don't want to do anything that's going to put the ball in jeopardy and really kind of hurt your team right now. You want to keep that clock moving. Here they're going to have about a 3rd and 5. 3rd and 6. Make the right play. You know, it's okay to punt. Your defense is playing fantastic. You know, you have a good kicking game. You know, put a lot of pressure on this Abilene Christian team to go the distance. Don't feel like you have to force anything if you hear some frost on this big 3rd down.
Drew Kronick has seen his team put up 286 yards of total offense. Abilene Christian 258 so far. Third down, Frost near side, falling to the turf and almost pulling it in. Brandon Mays. Good coverage as well, but boy, Mays would love to have that one back.
Yeah, I mean, great job right here by Harrison Frost, taking a shot and, you know, being confident in his arm and his ability to get the ball. Great throw. He put it in the spot where only his guy would be able to catch it. He just didn't come up with it. But again, it's okay. He didn't put it in a tight spot where it was going to be intercepted. He didn't take a sack where he could possibly fumble it. He allowed his team to come out, milk some time off of this clock. But his defense is playing great. So it's okay for the defense to get back on the field and hopefully try to end this game for him.
Jaron Parker on the coverage, just the third incomplete pass thrown today by Frost. Brooks West hit just after he made the catch, and he'll be dropped just inside the 25-yard line. Abilene Christian, they're down by 7. They're more than 1,000 miles from home. Here in the fourth quarter, they're going to get it back. 17-10, Mercer.
Really popular for high school.
Good guy. Really interesting guy. With Jared Singleton and Kristen Banks, Pete Gannady with you here at Five Star Stadium in Macon, Georgia, the Mercer Bears on Halloween. So that guy's ready to go. He's probably going to go right from a football game out to whatever type of trick-or-treating they're doing here in Middle Georgia. And Peyton Mansell, he can get you with his legs, and he shows right there just how he can do that.
You know, Pete, great job right there. He got a little trick-or-treat himself by just kind of pulling the ball down and getting the first down. But, again, it's just so great to be back in the booth with you, Pete. It's great to have fans in the stands and have some football to talk about.
And we've got ourselves what is setting up to be a pretty good stretch run in this ball game today. It's been tight throughout. Bears enjoying their biggest lead of the game earlier. Oof. Abilene Christian led 7-0. Hard charging and a hard pop, and who else but Lance Wise coming out of the pack in on his 11th tackle of the game as he ran right into Tyrese White.
This is how you feel the alley. Just comes in, I mean, fast, head down, makes the tackle, wraps up, gets the guy on the ground. I mean, that's what it's all about. It's really important right here, Pete, as they close down the fourth, as they're wrapping up the fourth quarter, for this young defense of Mercer, can they finish the game? Can they force Abilene Christian into third and longs and force them to do things they don't want to do and get off of the field? It's going to be very important as they get ready for conference play in the spring. Can they finish the game from a defensive standpoint?
You see Wise, a career high in tackles for the sophomore out of Marietta, Georgia. Mansell, he likes to roll to his left as a right-hander and then throw back. And that time, McConnell, and they're going to give him the 50-yard line. That's enough for a first down.
McConnell did a great job getting past the sticks, staying in bounds, tiptoeing, making a great catch, and securing the first down for this offensive unit. But again, Mercer has got to find a way to get off of the field and close this game in the fourth quarter. It's very critical, and this is a great coaching moment. This is something that the coaches can look at and showcase, here's where we could have done or been better. So really important as this young defense, which is good, a good defense, can they finish the game?
At least the third time today, a team has had it first and 10 at the 50. That time on the dump off to Lutz, the tight end, met immediately, and the big day just keeps on keeping on. For number 3, Lance Wise.
Look, let me tell you something. Lance Wise is bringing the hammer and bringing the boom. You know, he's quite smaller than this big tight end, but that does not fear. He has no fear. And he's coming down and meeting these guys at the point of attack, having a career day. He's going to be another star to compliment Isaac Dowling on this defense.
5'8", 179 is how they list him. A dozen tackles so far today. He's a safety who's playing like a linebacker so far this afternoon. No gain on the play, second down and 10. Dumps back to Dobbins. And Jeremiah Dobbins broke the first tackle and gets close to the first down.
Real close to a first down. Very, very sneaky play. You know, Dobbins did a great job kind of sneaking out the backfield and getting behind those big fellas, letting them get out there. You know, anytime you have linemen in space, as you see here, he kind of just sits behind his linemen and letting them get to their spots, man on man, and kind of, you know, wiggled his way to a first down. Great job of keeping the ball and keeping the drive alive because they need to put points on the board.
Indeed, a first and 10 at the Bears' 40-yard line. Mercer's defense trying to come up with another stop. And now, a timeout on the field. Our referee this afternoon is Jerry Wellmaker. And the fact that that happened right in front of the Mercer bench, the Bears had a good look and at whether or not Dobbins was able to get the first down yardage.
And the thing is, this Abilene Christian, I understand they're trying to get the call right, but the thing is, they're moving with momentum. You know, they're getting first downs, they're getting positive plays. It looks like, Peyton Manziel's kind of getting into a rhythm here, and now you have a stop and play to review whether it was a first down or not. You kind of hate that, but as you see here, I think it was a first down from this angle.
To your point, in the opening half, you mentioned it at halftime, the Bears held the ball for 9.5 minutes or so more than the Wildcats, and we noticed it really affected Manziel and that offense from getting into a rhythm. And
yeah,
here it looked like on this drive they were starting to feel it, and now timeout for the review, and if nothing else, as much a benefit to the Bears to kind of slow the momentum of the Wildcats.
And again, a young defense for the Mercer Bears. You know, so you know, right now they're in the huddle just kind of trying to get guys to regroup, refocus, make sure everyone understands their responsibilities so they can, you know, close this game out. Again, it's really easy to come out early in the game and have that energy and that focus, but can you finish it? And that's where sometimes experience or the lack thereof plays a huge factor for an offense or defense. In this particular case, Mercer's defense, you know, very young team led by young leaders. This is a great opportunity for coaches to use this moment to showcase, hey, let's finish strong, let's finish the way we started and make sure that we come out of here with a win.
Lance Wise is back to us. He has been front and center on that Bears defense throughout the game, a career high, a dozen stops so far. Every time we look up, number three is in the middle of the play.
And he's coming with bad intentions when he comes. I mean, he's really delivering the hammer on these guys, bringing that energy, bringing that fire. And that's the kind of attitude you want to see from a defensive player. That's the kind of momentum that, you know, really makes a difference for your defensive unit. And when you have guys like, you know, Lance Wise, and you have guys like Isaac Dowling, Johnson and Campbell who are making plays on defense, this is going to be a very interesting defensive unit and a very good team, I think, this spring.
And after the review, we couldn't hear what our referee Jerry Wellmaker had to say, but I do believe it will be to the benefit of the Bears as Dobbins will now be credited with a 9-yard reception. And it'll be third down and short.
Big play right here. So, you know, one thing you want to tell the defensive line is watch the ball. You know, nothing cheap. Watch the ball, no jumping off sides. You know, you don't want to give a free first down to this Abilene Christian offense.
Back to the Bears defense, and of course the NCAA has granted an extra year of eligibility for anyone in football that wants it. Most of these guys were coming back with a year or two of eligibility remaining anyway, the primary players on the Bears D. So it is a young group that is growing and growing up in a hurry here in the fall of 2020. Third down and short. And a first down for Dobbins, looking to break away. Wise able to trip him up and save a would-be touchdown.
Yeah, just a straight power right up the middle. Nothing sexy about this at all. Just coming right at you, hitting you in the mouth. And they did a great job as offensive line as far as being able to create a little bit of a hole for him to get through there. Did a great job. Almost broke that one to the house.
Jeremiah Dobbins has already surpassed his best output of the season and then some. He had 56 on the ground last week against Stephen F. Austin. That time he went for 18, 11 carries and 84 yards so far for the true freshman out of Lubbock. So a first and 10 as the Wildcats are knocking on the door of the red zone. Nice, the big fellow, the leaping grab. Johnson there for the Bears.
Yeah, great job by Johnson, because if he doesn't get it down on the ground, that might be a touchdown. But again, this Mercer defense, they have a bend but don't break mentality. Can they hold this, you know, Abilene team to only a field goal on this drive? It's huge. I mean, time is ticking away. Abilene's getting some momentum right now. They're looking for a touchdown, and they need to finish the drive with a touchdown, because you know, they give the ball back to this Mercer team, only getting a field goal, they might not see the ball again.
These reminds me a lot of the receiver at VMI who did such great work last year. And, well, there is a timeout called. It'll be the Wildcats using their second of this second half. Jacob Harris is the player I was comparing to Nice. Well, they hope he can step up big as we continue on in a seven-point game.
This will be a mix.
Ingalls College football coming to you this afternoon from Five Star Stadium here on the campus of Mercer University in Macon, Georgia. 8.5 to play in our fourth quarter. The Bears up by 7. Abilene Christian trying to get the tying points. They led early on 7-0, but Mercer able to come back with a second quarter TD and then take the lead before the half, and they've been in front since. They were tied up at 10 apiece. A Bears touchdown in the third quarter put them up by 7. Abilene Christian moved up to Division I back in 2013. Second down, quick little fake on the pitch, and then Mansell just inside the 15-yard line. It'll bring up third and short situation. Most famous football alum for Abilene Christian, a fine running back in the 70s for the Philadelphia Eagles, Wilbert Montgomery, who then went on to a long career as an NFL assistant coach.
Yeah, you know, right here, Pete, big third down. You know, who on this defense besides, you know, Lance Wise, besides Isaac Dowell, is going to step up and make a play? You know, big third down to force Abilene into a fourth down situation. Who's going to step up?
Third down had been an issue coming in, but they're 50% this afternoon, and looks like they will convert another. Will the Wildcats? Good hard running that time by Tyrese White, who's been limited this afternoon. We've seen more of Dobbins out of their backfield.
Just a simple power play right up the middle. Nothing sexy again, but again, Dowling with a great tackle on that play to prevent it from even being a bigger play. But someone on this Mercer defense has to step up. You know, you can't continue to allow this Abilene Christian team to just move at will down the field. Who's going to step up and make a play, create a turnover, create a second, a third and long? Someone has to step up at this time.
Little flip in front. Darius Lewis looking for room. Bears read it well. Second down.
Nice play. Little jet sweep motion. You know, the Abilene's trying to do to kind of stretch this defense. But again, great pursuit by this defensive unit. You see all the red jerseys around the ball. A lot of gang tackling, getting guys on the ground. Second and long. Again, this is an opportunity for this Mercer team to get a lot of experience that they can't get in practice, to be able to close out a game on the defensive side of the ball.
Bears trying to step up big once again inside of the red zone. Mansell, Clark trying to get in space, but a good job coming across. And Kobe Clark was hit hard that time. And boy, give credit on the stop to Chris Hill. He had a sack earlier, and that time, Hill, the redshirt freshman, coming through with a big hit.
You know, it's plays like this, I'm glad I'm sitting in the booth talking about the game and not playing it. That was a big blow. You know, the fact that he was able to pop up from that was just amazing. But we haven't called his name a lot, Kobe Clark, here in the second half, in the fourth quarter, as much. But they need him to step up. They need other guys on this offensive unit, especially now, third and long. You know, who's going to make a play for this Abilene Christian team to give them either a first down or a touchdown?
They can get a first down without scoring. They have to get inside of the two. There Mansell is. And dropped by Brooks West.
Can't have that on the team. You got it. If it touches your hand, you've got to bring that one in. Tough one right there. Now creates a fourth and long situation. You know, he started running before he brought the ball in. You just can't do that. You've got to, you know, who's going to be that guy that's going to help Kobe Clark, that's going to help A.J. McConnell? The opportunity's there, but someone's got to step up.
So for a second time today, the Wildcats will go for it on fourth down. They converted early on in the contest. And you really have to with the ability that Mercer has had to keep the clock going when they've had the ball. Fourth down and 9 from the 10. And Mansell, he took a look, and he will use the final timeout here in the second half for Abilene Christian. Peyton Mansell trying to get his first win as a starting quarterback at Abilene Christian. Big snap coming up on the other side of this timeout. Abilene Christian using their final timeout. A huge fourth down play upcoming for them.
Huge fourth down play. They've had a lot of time to talk about it. Right now, you're asking yourself, you know, who's going to be that go-to guy? And that person's Kobe Clark. From a defensive standpoint, you know that's their biggest, impact player. So trying to find a way to bracket him, double-team him, because you know the ball has to be going his way first.
They were 10th in FCS last season nationally in fourth down conversions. They're 1-for-1 today. This is a 4th and 9. They can get a first down just inside the 2. Mansell, we've seen him run today toward the end zone. Caught, touchdown.
Who else? That's your playmaker. He's got to get the ball. And no matter what you do, he has got to find a way to get the ball. And that's exactly what Peyton Manziel did. He rolled out the pocket, gave his guy time to get open. He was open initially, but he found that soft spot in the zone and just sat right there. Great connection, great job. Big PAT right here, though, Pete.
Third touchdown catch this season for Kobe Clark, the junior out of Sweetwater, Texas, a former walk-on who's become their best player a year ago. He set a program record with 87 receptions, and that's TD toss number 4 on the year for his quarterback, Peyton Mansell.
And, you know, slightly disappointing, I'm not going to lie, from a Mercer standpoint, your defense had an opportunity to really put a stop to this Abilene Christian momentum, but they didn't do that, and they didn't have anyone else to kind of help, you know, Dowling or Wes, you know, who's had a phenomenal game. They haven't had anyone really help step up on that defensive unit, which is a little bit disappointing if you're Mercer.
Very important extra point up and good for Blair Zepeda, and we are again tied, this time at 17. So take another look. Mansell seems to throw back across his body quite a bit.
He does that a lot, and I guess depending on, you know, who you ask, that, at least to me, I've always been told never to do that. But, you know, it worked for them. You know, Peyton Manziel, he's definitely an athletic quarterback. You know, he can make plays with his feet. Great job by Kobe Clark. Again, 9 catches. He's been targeted 10 times. That's about the number that they wanted. They wanted to make sure he had at least 8 to 10 touches this game. And he's shown you why he's their impact and best player on the team. But, again, Mercer has an opportunity now on offense to go back out here 5:49, all 3 of their timeouts, and win the ball game. You don't need a touchdown. You need 3 points. And they have the offensive weapons. They have a slew of backs. They have a quarterback who's done a great job all day of protecting the football, being a great game manager. Can he manage this last 5:49 to get his team in field goal position to win the ball game?
Clark, part of another 200-yard passing day for Mansell, his 4th in as many starts this season for ECU. Now 205 in the air for Mansell.
What a great way to bring back the season, right, Pete?
Yeah, man. Wow. Zepeda getting ready to kick it away. Johnson and Fred Davis back deep for the Bears. Davis will watch it sail over his head. It'll be a touchback, and Mercer with 5:49 to go, now in a tie ball game. We'll get it back. Trying to put together a winning run in this lone home game of the fall. Drew Kronick, his first home game as the head coach, seeking his first victory at the helm of the Bears. And the SoCon trying to get a first win during the fall season.
And you know, the thing about this on this first play is very important. You know, just kind of run a play that's going to give Frost some, you know, confidence. You know, does not have to be anything crazy. Does not have to be, you know, he does not have to win the ball game in one play. Just run your offense. You know, get some confidence. Get that first play out the way. Get that first down for the drive, and hopefully they can result in some points.
Wing back carry that time. And Ethan Durham, a freshman out of Canton, Georgia. We've seen him from a rushing standpoint. That was his first carry of the game. Mercer leading in total yards for most of this game, but Abilene Christian up in that category now. 334 to 286. Johnson looking for room as he cuts back in and bring up third down.
Third down, third and manageable, not bad. Great job. There was nothing deep. He wanted to go deep initially, but Abilene Christian did a fantastic job of taking that threat away. And so Harrison Frost has done what he's done all day. Go to his check down, make the smart throw, and create a 3rd and 5, and hopefully his team can convert.
Note that Mercer still has all three of its second half timeouts. Abilene Christian has used each of theirs. And on a third down and four, the Bears on the afternoon, 7 of 11. Frost, pressure coming from Gibbons, and it's incomplete. Intended for Mays. And quite frankly, I got to think that the Bears are fortunate that ball was underthrown. It might have been picked off.
Might have been picked off, and I tell you, Jack Gibbons came off the edge and no one was blocking him. You know, he almost made the created a sack fumble on that particular play, but great job by this Abilene Christian defense of getting off the field and forcing Mercer to punt. I tell you, Mercer's had a lot of success on offense today. Wouldn't be surprised if we see a thriller here at the end.
Roy Richardson on the coverage, fair catch called for. On the punt by Gupel, Jordan Brooks West reeling it in at his own 36-yard line. So, I mentioned the timeouts for Mercer because if the defense can step up here, they can still preserve a good part of this 4 minutes and 33 seconds, try to get the ball back and put together a winning drive. But Abilene Christian thinking the exact same thing as they get it back here with plenty of time to go.
Well, the thing is, though, Pete, you got to remember, being that this is a young defense, you hope that they have short-term memory because last time they were out here, they gave up that big touchdown play. And if that's, you know, sometimes with young players, it's hard to teach them to forget a bad play and to move on to what's next. And hopefully they, you know, they can do that because Abilene Christian, they have momentum, just had a big stop on offense, and they're looking to take the top off the defense right here.
Looking long, Mansell for Clark. Stride for stride with him defensively for the Bears, and a good job by Richie Coffey, the Bandit. And a ball that really wobbled. Clark would have had to really do something to pull that one in.
Yeah, and he wishes he had this one back, could have thrown that one a little bit better. You know, Kobe Clark's type of guy, it doesn't matter if you got one guy or two guys on him. If you throw a decent ball, he can probably go get it. Let's give the big fella some credit. You know, they did really well on that pass pro to give enough time for the quarterback to make a good throw. But, you know, hopefully this Abilene Christian team, you see here, they're running the ball off the right side of the offensive line, picking up 4 or 5 yards, creating third and short to try to continue the momentum to capitalize on this drive.
So they try to take a shot on first down. Dobbins gets some 5 on second down. The TD from Mansell to Clark moments ago came on a second fourth down try of the game. They're perfect 2 for 2, but they certainly don't want to have that choice here. They'd love to convert on this 3rd down and 5. Mansell, and there's McConnell. Wise able to pull him down. 17th tackle in the game for Lance Wise. That is a season high for the Bears defense, and he builds on his career high.
You know, Wise saved a bigger play because this obviously was the first down, but if he doesn't make this tackle, he could have taken this one to the house. But great job by this Abilene Christian offensive unit, giving their quarterback enough time to survey the field and see where the right matchup is and make a good throw. And again, able to convert and keep the drive alive. They don't have any timeout, so, you know, time's of the essence.
You saw the tight shot of McConnell, and he takes it on the end around. Stood up shy of the 40-yard line, but good yards on first down. Just as the Bears have done during the ball game today, Abilene Christian also stretching out the field and using the horizontal concept to get a few yards downfield.
And by doing that, it forces the safety like West to start, you know, sprinting at the point of the snap. And that creates, you know, a lot of pressure on your corners because you've got guys like Kobe Clark where if you leave him one-on-one without safety help, he's going to beat your guy every time. And so, you know, being able to stretch and use all of the field is very important as this Abilene Christian offense seems to be getting stronger as the game progresses.
Under 3 minutes to go. Quick throw over the middle and caught. Bullet pass to Darius Lewis. It'll go for another first down for the Wildcats.
First down, moving the chains, keeping the clock moving. And again, this Mercer defense, they're being challenged. They're being tested. You know, they gave up a touchdown last drive. You can't help but wonder how much of that is still replaying in their heads, being that they're such a young defensive unit.
They will work from the 35 of the Bears, so that is shaping up to be another good-looking drive put together by this Wildcats team. Another shovel right in front of him by Mansell. Good read that time. defensively by the Bears. They have used that little toss sweep, if you will, several times during the game. That time, Davon Johnson, though, was stopped after maybe picking up a yard. Now Mercer will use one of those three remaining timeouts with exactly 2 minutes to go in regulation.
I think this is a good timeout. I think this timeout gives the coaching staff of Mercer a chance to look at their defensive unit, be able to figure out.
And they add four
seconds of that.
Gotcha. It gives them a chance to look at their defensive unit to kind of see where they are. You know, look them in the eyes and make sure and answer any, you know, questions that they have at this point. Because, again, this is an opportunity for this young Mercer defense to learn how to close out a game. They gave up a touchdown last drive. How can they make sure that they, you know, give up just a field goal or get some kind of a big play, a turnover or something to get the ball back to their offense? How can they learn from this opportunity? And that's what these coaches are looking for right now.
In normal times here in late October, we would be in the heart of the SoCon season. If you just happened up to this game today and didn't know what was going on in the world, you'd think you were watching a tight Southern Conference matchup between a couple of teams probably in the hunt for the league title. It's been that kind of competitive game. It doesn't seem like a non-conference game between a couple of teams that had never seen each other and are separated by over 1,000 miles.
Well, it looks the logo for the Western Carolina, it looks like, I mean, the logo for Abilene Christian looks like Western Carolina's logo. So you can kind of say you have Western and Mercer playing right now if you wanted to. But you're right, Pete. You have two teams that are competing really hard. And, you know, you have football in the fall. You know, what else can you ask for?
And they will see Western Carolina here in the SoCon season in the winter and spring. Dobbins, he's been busy today. Flag thrown in the backfield. We've seen very few penalty markers here in the second half.
Yeah, that was definitely a hold by the big fella.
Holding, 76, offense. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. Replay, second down.
And Pete, you just hate that because not only is that a big penalty that take, you know, but it kicks you out of field goal range. You know, it puts more pressure now for your offensive unit to kind of have to throw the ball down the field. And so big penalty takes a lot of the energy out of the offense. But hopefully being second down, they can try to get half of that they lost on this play.
So it brings up a second down and 19 all the way back at the Mercer 44. Off play action, Mansell with pressure. And he will tuck it. Out of bounds he goes. Wise was there to make sure he went out. Good gain, got a lot of those yards back to set up a third down and significantly more manageable.
Much more manageable, and I tell you what, you know, that was like the perfect play after that holding penalty. But now you got third and short. You know, try to convert if you can, but if you can't, it sets you up for a very long field goal, which will give you the lead. And with the minute 49 left, that seems like the best play right now.
Blair Zepeda, their place kicker, 1 for 2 today. Missed on a 44-yarder earlier in this second half. In fact, earlier in this fourth quarter. Mansell. On third down, little shovel ahead, and he was able to find his tight end. Ooh. Hohenstein pulling it down. And enough for a first down.
This guy looks like Johnny Manziel, I'll tell you. The way he's just, you know, kind of creating his own plays. I mean, he literally almost takes a sack, but makes, you know, just a little flick of the wrist. And then, you know, right here, the ball almost comes out. But he's able to hold on tight to it and get the first down yardage. And again, the clock keeps moving, and it looks like they're in field goal range.
Abilene Christian trying to avoid a second straight overtime game in what would be their fourth in the past two seasons. White back in, has a hole, and able to push down to the 15-yard line. Now if you're the Bears, you need to start using your timeouts, and they will, because they may need some time to at least try to get themselves into field goal position.
Second charge, timeout and a half.
So far today, the touchdowns, this the first for Dobbins and the Wildcats, came after an early Mercer fumble. Bears able to respond after Abilene Christian had fumbled. Second quarter into the end zone, Brandon Marshall on a 13-yard run. Bears led 10-7 at the break. Harrison Frost connecting over the middle to the freshman Zach Davis, his first career touchdown in his first home game. He is going to be a fine player in this offense. And then earlier in this fourth quarter, extending the play as he does so well, Mansell on a fourth down, they had to convert. And there's Kobe Clark, top receiver on this team and the right guy in the right place at the right time.
I wouldn't be surprised if they try to, you know, being second and short, if they try to take a shot to the end zone with Kobe Clark again right now, because you do have third and fourth down in your back pocket. If I'm Mercer's defense, you got to find a way to bend but don't break. But who's going to make a play? Someone has got to step up and make a play, and that's probably what those defensive coaches were saying in that last timeout. Because they've got to have short-term memory. You can't think about the last drive where you gave up a touchdown. You can't keep kicking yourself because you've given up this many yards on this particular drive. But wouldn't be surprised if they take a shot at Kobe Clark right here.
Baron King in that Bears defense instead sees a handoff. Tyrese wide enough for a first down.
24 on the carry, takes it down inside the 10 to the 9.
They're going
to
milk this clock down. Again, probably try to give it to, you know, Dobbins or White. Continue to run the football, see if they can pop one open to get to the end zone, being 9 yards out.
One turnover in the game for Abilene Christian. They came in having given it up 7 times in their first 3 games. That one fumble, though, was costly. It led to the first Mercer touchdown. First and goal. They'll keep it on the ground, and Dobbins trying to cut outside, and a penalty flag is thrown.
Might be another hold, I think, Pete.
21 on the carry, including flag down on the play.
Which would definitely be a backbreaker, because that's adding more yards that your field goal kicker is going to have to now tack on when he just missed one early in this half.
From the kicker Zepeda's perspective, if and when he does go out there, the wind will be blowing from his left to his right, and he missed his last attempt wide right. He certainly had the distance from 44 yards away.
Offense. 10 yards for previous spot. Replay, first down.
John Crisp, the guilty party.
And those are the kinds of penalties as a coach in this culture you're trying to change. You know, those are the type of plays, a holding or, you know, carrying the ball in the wrong hand, you know, that causes a turnover. Those are the kind of things that you just can't have if you're trying to create a championship program. And that's one of the things that I know Coach has harped about all week, and that he wants to change in this program going forward.
11th play of this drive, and that time simply trying to kneel down instead of clocking it. They're trying to center it up as we've got just a few seconds to go. Now he'll clock it. Boy, that was almost perilous for Mansell. First he ran it, realized the clock wouldn't stop, and they were able just to get a snap off with 3 seconds to go, and Mansell clocking it. So now Zepeda in the spotlight once more. Missed his first field goal of the season last week. That might have made a difference in the eventual overtime loss against Stephen F. Austin. This time he's going to try it from 37 yards away, right in the middle of the field.
Going to call a timeout, ice him a little bit.
And Drew Kronick indeed doing just that.
You know, the thing, Pete, you kind of know they're going to call the timeout. I've always wondered why the snapper doesn't, you know, go ahead and still snap the ball to give his kicker a kind of a free practice kick to kind of see it go through first. You know, I mean, to me, I feel like that's something I would tell my long snapper. Hey, look, be aware they have 2 timeouts. They're probably going to try to ice us. If you hear the whistle, just go ahead and snap it and let our guy kind of get a little practice kick in.
You know, those special teams guys in practice are the loneliest. They're always over there just in their small group. You wonder, though, how much therapy goes on for situations just like this.
Look, all I know is I played center, and it was a lot of pressure sometimes to make sure that you have a clean, good snap. But I'm never going to talk bad about a kicker, because the amount of pressure on this young man right now is more than I want to have. You know, so you got to love your kicker. You can't live with him, can't live without him. You know, you can say that if you want to, but these guys are special, and there's a reason why they're on special teams, because of these type of special moments.
Bears still have a timeout. Will Abilene Christian get the winner here, or will we see more action? Kick on the way, has the distance, and it's good! And Abilene Christian traveling more than 1,000 miles, and it proves to be the final 37 yards for the winner. You see the celebration near midfield.
Your final
There's a Wildcat down a few yards back toward the goalpost, but Abilene Christian in game number four for them this fall, able to come in and break the hearts of the Mercer Bears and their faithful with a 20-17 victory on Blair Zepeda's second made field goal of the game.
Game, Abilene Christian. I mean, that was truly a game, a comeback. You know, we said in the opening, this team is one that gets stronger as the game goes on, and their playmakers made plays when it counted, especially Kobe Clark there at the end.
Our play of the game brought to you by Ford. A disappointing conclusion on what was a day of football celebration here at Five Star Stadium. The Bears will cap off the fall portion of their schedule and now get ready for SoCon play to begin in February. They were anxious to play at home. Everybody was anxious to be a part of this home game. And in the end, Abilene Christian rallying in the fourth quarter with 10 unanswered points for a 20-17 victory. They improved to 1-3 on the season, getting ready for their first home game coming up next week out in Texas. Been a pleasure, Jared. And on behalf of Jared Singleton and Kristen Banks, Pete Hannity saying so long from Macon, Georgia.